Oh, it's all Capitals in this one, Ray.
Yeah, and Washington's played almost a perfect game. Kolzig's made the saves he's had to. Lang has played very well. Yager's been a presence right from the opening whistle for Washington.
All right, Minnesota scored the fewest goals of any playoff team in the NHL this year. Colorado, they've scored many more. And that man, come playoff time, is always ready. Joe Sakic and the Avalanche next against the Wild.
Intense, isn't it?
For in-your-face home theater action, come to Best Buy. From Sony plasma TVs to Bose surround sound, we'll help find the system that's right for you. Get into the action at Best Buy.
Tradition.
A look on the other guy's face.
To be my own Manning.
Being a woman.
Because last year,
millions of little girls.
Every athlete is fueled by something.
Don't look at me like that.
We just finished riding.
We'll go out tomorrow. I promise.
Oh, all right.
The very eager, very stylish, very versatile Suzuki Katana. It's always looking for fun.
This guy tells his buddy there's nothing he'd like more than a new riding lawnmower. Nothing too expensive, he says, but nothing's gonna give me any trouble. Nothing too complicated. Nothing better than making it look good and getting on with it. His buddy looks at him and says, nothing runs like a deer. Introducing the John Deere 100 series. Durability, precision, and exclusive support. For anyone who wants a tractor that's easy to run, easy to maintain, and easy to afford.
Check out new Close Shave Barbasol Gel.
Close.
Goodbye irritation.
Who's next?
Love Close, hate irritation? Better buy new Barbasol Gel.
Stanley Cup versus Niagara Falls. Let's see who attracts more attention. Here it is. That's right, you're not seeing things, folks. Pretty cool, huh? This is your wedding present.
Can we just take that?
Is it pretty?
Want to get your name on there?
A real cup?
Check that. Are we ever lucky?
Is this like the eighth wonder of the world?
Won their NHL record ninth consecutive division title. That's nice, but that's the regular season. So far, the playoffs have not been kind to the home team. Peter Forsberg looks to fix that. And you always remember your first. Marian Gaborik and the Wild are ready for their first ever Stanley Cup playoff game. Tonight, in Denver, the journey begins for the Minnesota Wild and the Colorado Avalanche. The Avs are fresh off their record ninth consecutive division crowd after a furious finish to the gate. Now this two-time Cup winner looks hungry once again for yet another title. Minnesota is the new kid in town, and the Wild have given their fans the first playoff berth in franchise history and shown their skeptics the door. Round one, game one, next. This is the Pepsi Center in Denver, Colorado. A capacity crowd will be on hand for game one of the Western Conference quarterfinal series. The Avalanche, the 3 seed, against the Minnesota Wild, the 6 seed in the Western Conference. Hi, everybody, and good evening. With Darren Bang, I'm Steve Levy. Welcome to the Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN2. For the Wild tonight, their first ever playoff game. Everything that happens is the answer to a trivia question. But they draw Colorado, and Panger, the Avs on the final day of the season win the division title, get the scoring lead and the goal scoring lead.
They waited till the last minute, but that was their ultimate goal to begin. They wanted to win the division. They set their sights on that. Who could have imagined that this line and individual individually. Peter Forsberg winning the scoring title. Milan Hayduk winning the Rocket Richard Trophy. Most goals. He scored his first 50 goals in one season. Alex Tanguay, though, has been a big key on the left side for this line. This line has been the best line in the National Hockey League for at least the last 2 months.
The most recognizable name on the Minnesota Wild by their coach, Jacques Lemaire. He's known for his defensive systems. Well, how does he slow down the Avs?
Well, he's got two guys that have been unbelievable defensively. Antti Laaksonen on the wing and Wes Walls at center ice. They'll go against Peter Forsberg, but clearly the pressure does go on their goaltender. Dwayne Roloson has had a brilliant breakthrough season in goal for the Wild. He gets the nod over Manny Fernandez, and it will be imperative for Roloson to make the first couple of saves and get on a roll.
If Roloson is to get some goal support tonight or in this series, it'll likely come from young superstar Marion Gaborik. He'll play in his first NHL playoff game, shooting against the master, Patrick Roy.
For the go-ahead goal, under two to play. Across.
Hit it.
Audio, fantasy games, and official NHL merchandise. The place to go is NHL.com on MSN.
The Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN2, brought to you by Labatt Blue, imported from Canada. Look up Sea Blue. Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. And Southwest Airlines, official airline of the National Hockey League. Ready to rock and roll, the Stanley Cup playoffs underway from the Pepsi Center in Denver, Colorado. The last time we saw the Avalanche in a playoff series, in a playoff game, they lost 7-0. Game 7 against Detroit in the Western Conference Finals. And this series is now underway. Paul Dvorsky and Mick Magoo, the referees. Greg Dvorsky and Scott Driscoll will work the lines. The Wild in the visiting green, and the Avs in the home white. Greg DeVries trying to push it ahead. Kent runs into Antti Laaksonen, and he finds Wes Walls. Walls to Gaborik, fake the shot, and the Wild look to set things up inside the zone. They start power against power with Gaborik on the ice for Minnesota and the Forsberg line on. For the Avs, Willie Mitchell got the first shot away.
And there's the defenseman for the Minnesota Wild jumping up into the play on the weak side and getting a quality scoring chance.
And across the line now. Here's Hayduk on the back end, stopped by Wallace, and he's in the game. Nick Schultz will push it ahead on the far side. Pascal Dupuis couldn't handle it. Race to the puck. Derek Morris back for the touch. Icing call. 59 seconds in.
Well, Patrick Roy has been sterling in goal from January on, but I think more importantly is what he has done against Minnesota. On December 21st, he made 45 saves and won the game. February 15th, 36 shots against and 34 saves, including five by Pascal Dupuis. Don't think that the Wild don't put pucks on net. They've proven that here against Colorado.
Back to the point. Sakic won the draw. Blake got the shot, but it was blocked. And here's Sakic dangling with the puck. Sakic struggled offensively down the stretch in the regular season, but it's a whole new season. But Taglia got the shot away on the wraparound, and Roloson, without his stick, he had the puck.
Last 20 games, Dwayne Roloson made 11 starts, went 5-4-1, had one no decision. Steve, in the four losses that he had, they scored zero goals for him. So not much offensive support. He has been a rock in goal for the Wild. Here's a little wraparound play there. A lot of congestion in front of the net. Battaglia tries the last wraparound, and Battaglia took a slap shot off the foot to begin that shift off the hard shot from Rob Blake.
Off the draw. Blake will get it again. Big shot save. Oh, stop Roloson. And Roloson is in the game in a big way early on.
What a magnificent save that is, leaning towards his left. Talked about it early. I mean, that's exactly what Colorado wants to do, is set this young team on its heels early on and try to get Rolison, or any goalie for that matter, thinking a little bit. Well, clearly here, Rolison makes an outstanding save through traffic, gets down low on the butterfly. This one here on Joe Sakic's backhander. Joe might have pulled that a little bit. It went in towards the body of Rolison, who sprawls to his left and makes a save with the elbow. After that play, his own teammate, right now he's the captain, Cliff Ronning, had pushed one of the players right on top of Rolison rather awkwardly. And we'll see it from this angle here, because Blake's shot, he has been prominent early on here with two quality shots. One was blocked by his own teammate. This backhander by Joe, that's a wonderful look, guys, on the reverse angle. It hit the shaft of a wild stick before then caroming into the goaltender, Rolison.
Didn't expect a wide open series, but a minute 15 in, we've already had six quality scoring chances. Four belonging to Colorado, and they continue to hem the Wild in early. Centering feed, knocked away by Sekeras. That shot. And Rolison was looking behind him as it's finally cleared out the center. Marchman is hit by Park, and finally the Wild gets some puck possession. Sergei Zoltok will go back to try to get some forechecking pressure and can't. Brian Wilsey in the lineup for Colorado. He's able to chip it out to center. Colorado has scratched Mike Keane along with Riku Hall and DJ Smith. The Keane scratch is somewhat surprising, a veteran of the playoff wars. Sent in softly. Nick Schultz is back for it. Fires it right back out. And all the way down the ice. Waugh will play it. Up the near side for Peter Forsberg. Brad Bombardier, who serves as the captain of the Wild, is a scratch. He hopes to get back for game two of this series. That'll be Saturday afternoon back here in Denver on ABC. Long shot from Gavrik. No problem from Waugh. And he'll hang on.
Well, Jacques Lemaire, after the morning skate, this is a veteran of 8 Stanley Cups as a player, 2 in management with Montreal, and 1 as a head coach in New Jersey. And he came on and said, "We're all nervous. We're a very nervous team right now." And I looked at you and said,
I was going to buy it, Banger.
I wasn't buying it once. And now I'm not saying that they're not a nervous bunch, but the way he came out and said it, completely, and this is perfect from a coaching's point of view, I would imagine, defending the players and how they're feeling right away. He's not sure how they're going to react. That's why Pierre-Marc Bouchard is not playing. He's not sure how game one's going to go. He doesn't want to put him into a bad situation. He is wonderful at protecting his players.
Pierre-Marc Bouchard is the second youngest player in the National Hockey League. Only Rick Nash of Columbus is younger. And they're just offside ahead of the play. What about the playoff pressure for Minnesota? We asked Andrew Burnett.
I don't think we should put too much pressure on ourselves in being playoff performers. Let's just be hockey performers. Let's go play the way that we should be playing, the way that we can play. I don't think we should be, we're not, we've never put pressure on ourselves all year. Why start now?
Andrew Burnett in his first playoff appearance since 96 as a member of the Washington Capitals. 11 players in the Wild roster have never played in a Stanley Cup playoff game.
But he's right though, Steve, excuse me. Why start now? Do the same things you've done all year long. And in practice this morning, they did the same things as normal. They've been very cohesive in terms of Jacques Lemaire getting them out for dinners, after games, before games. So they are one unit that talks hockey 24 hours a day.
Matt Johnson had the big hit so far for Minnesota. Put Morris down in the corner. And Morris responds with a hit on Johnson. Johnson, the resident tough guy for the Wild. Scott Parker is on the ice for Colorado. And they'll skate by one another. We get the whistle.
This is a good pinch by Morris, because if you can congest the wingers and the opposition from going D to D and then up to the winger on the hash marks, if your D can read that right away, you're eliminating any potential transition or breakout. And if Morris is a split second left on that, late on that play, then he's going to get burnt, because it's a chip out over the boards and it's an odd man break. But he was right on the mark. Great timing.
Here's Tanguay from the angle. The shot was blocked by Hajduk. That shot was stopped. And this line buzzing. Here's Tanguay, tries to make the move. Hajduk can't get to it. Taken away by Nick Schultz. Schultz will shoot it far side for Willie Mitchell.
Can't get into the zone. Hendrickson is hit down from behind, but the Wild are able to get it away. Nick Schultz, he's older than Mark Bouchard is, but not by much. Nick Schultz is only 20 years old. And it's sent softly to center ice.
See right now, I'm sure Minnesota here, they're keeping Wallace on the ice with Gabrick. Well, Dupuis on the ice. Loxonen's the normal winger there. But it's an interesting matchup to try to keep your hands on because of how frequently Jacques Lemaire puts other guys in that place.
Here's Wallace able to get it ahead for Loxonen. The shot right on. And Wallace has some trouble with that one. And he'll hang on.
Well, a couple of good chances at both ends. Peter Forsberg had a wonderful chance here coming out to the faceoff circle. This might have deflected off the defenseman's stick, but it went clearly off the crook of the arm of goaltender Dwayne Rolison. An outstanding save with the glove as actually Peter Forsberg was looking at the screen overhead.
Joltok tried to move it ahead for the Wild off the faceoff. Tricky play, but DeVries gets to it and shoots in. Rolison got a piece of it, but not enough. Here's Bates Battaglia on with Reinfreck and Sakic for the time being. Here's Sakic in the corner, finds Reinfreck now. Back to the point, kept in by Foot. Here's Reinfreck. His puck possession almost makes it seem like it's a Colorado power play. Philippe Kubo was able to block that shot and send it to the corner. Two on two, battle along the wall, left to Rolison. Dangerously cleared up the middle, but nobody was home. So icing will be called as Foot goes back for the touch.
One of the great young stars for the Minnesota Wild is obviously Marian Gaborik, and he's a player that you're gonna clearly watch every single shift. Although, like most young players, he's only in his third year, there's gonna be a drop-off period for a player of his caliber when he's one of the few, you know, God-gifted players that can go end-to-end on this hockey club. But right now, we've seen his offense tail off. Last 20 games, Gaborik only has 3 goals for the Minnesota Wild. Shot there from the faceoff, but they've got other areas that they can score goals in. They have to do it as a team, though.
Puck on the goal line, and Rolison will hang on.
Big question here is, when the whistle goes, did that trickle in behind him? He looked fairly confident on that little wraparound that he was going to keep it. Tell you what, Colorado's seen something. They're really trying to jam pucks, aren't they? Jam them on both sides of the net. Seeing that if he fades away from his post, and there from the Southwest Airlines goal cam, the whistle went, the puck was on the goal line, and then it came up, out. I would absolutely agree with the officials there in saying that that is no goal.
Shots are 8-2 so far for Colorado. Face off to the left of Rolison, who's deep in a crouch, really deep in his crouch. It is face-off stance. Now straighten up just a little bit. Centered off the stick of Rolison, right through the crease. Dowd will get to it. He tried to reverse it deeper into his own end and wound up turning it right back over to Colorado. Here's Wilsey. Slap shot. Rolison got a piece to kick into the corner. Back behind the net. A band tried to whack at it. Wilsey can't get to it. Far side. Dowd is deep in his own end. Finally, Minnesota will get to it. Talk about weathering the storm here in Colorado with the Avalanche. This is a good example of that. Onside, Tanguay for Hajduk. Rolison got across. It is all Colorado except on the scoreboard. Back behind the net. Here's Forsberg for Tanguay. Center, Hajduk couldn't get there. Schultz able to break it up. Minnesota comes back out. Here's Ronnie, little drop pass. Loxonen was able to swing around Marchment. Wah got to the puck, put it off the glass, and it goes into the crowd. Scoreless from Denver.
This is Labatt Blue, the clean, crisp lager imported daily from Canada. Its refreshing, honest taste comes from a...
Sorry! My bad. I got carried away a little. We're gonna need another blue over here. This one's spilled. Can we get another blue, please? Cold, like this one.
Recently, all the winners of the Car and Driver Best Pickup Award got together for a little reunion. It's good to see everyone again. Silverado, the 3-time winner, the only winner of Car and Driver's Best Pickup Award. Silverado, the truck from Chevy. The most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Miss Lewis.
It is Miss, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Could you tell me again how you use 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls?
Well, I just dialed down the center.
With what, Miss Lewis? With what?
You dialed down the center with 1-800-CALL-ATT. It's free for you, cheap for them.
So good.
You sure this guy's a cop?
Save on every call. Dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
The Transporter on DVD. Now with 15 minutes of unrated extended fight scenes. The Transporter. Buy it Tuesday.
Peter Forsberg went through traffic in the middle of the ice. Look, he looked off Wes Walls there and Cliff Ronning. Made a good pass to Tanguay, who makes a brilliant backhander right up to the right-handed Milan Hayduk. That was a save off the right part of the body, the inside of the blocker, the right side of the hip by Dwayne Rolison, who has withstood the challenge here early.
Hendrickson beats Sakic on the faceoff. They're fortunate just to get it in deeper, at least momentarily. Here's Dupuis, let it go. Right pad save by Patrick Waugh. Marchman will get to it. And the Wild finally get a chance to finish their checks. Minnesota cannot be pleased with the pace of this game, or at least from the start, playing right into the hands of the high-flying Avalanche.
Nope, but there's good news in that for the Minnesota Wild, and that is it's still 0-0, 7 minutes in. It takes some time, as Jacques Lemaire was telling us today, for players to adapt to the pressurized situation. And clearly, they're going to make some adjustments. And as he said, the first period is going to be all about experience. The second period is going to be all about more experience for our group.
Here's Eric Messier, able to pick off the pass. Out at center, across the red line, will fire it around. Rolison directing traffic. Pretty good hit there by DeVries. Might have gotten away with a bit of an elbow, but icing his call. We remain scoreless. Tomorrow night, the Stanley Cup playoffs roll on with an ESPN2 doubleheader beginning at 7 Eastern and 4 Pacific. Jeremy Roenick and the Flyers look to win on home ice. Alexander McGillney the hat last night. Mike Modano and the Stars look to rally on home ice against Tommy Salo and those high-flying Oilers. The action begins 7 Eastern on ESPN2. For more, log on to ESPN.com.
Tony Granato, good job getting the Forsberg line out there on the ice. Face off to the right side of Rolison.
And off the face-off, Ronning able to get to it. Pushes it out ahead for Richard Park. He'll shoot in softly. Wah turns it right over to Ronning. Touched with a high stick. And that's the reason for the whistle.
Well, Patrick Waugh's had a few shots early on. Pascal Dupuis is a player that will never hesitate to shoot the puck. It's one of his strengths. And what he does, he just looks down after years and years of practicing at home. His father was a draft pick of the Quebec Nordiques. And he has stressed throughout his childhood, shoot the darn puck. And he did so there. Patrick makes a good save going down to the butterfly.
Dupuis this season set a franchise record for Minnesota, keeping in mind they're only in their third year. A plus 17 for Pascal Dupuis, a new franchise record for Minnesota Wild. At center, shot right back in. Waugh thought about it. Foot will go to it, chased by Gaborik. And it's cleared all the way out to center. Brad Brown will get to it for Minnesota. Shoots it around. Waugh will leave it there for Foot. He drops it off for DeVries. Up the near side for Serge Aubin. Out ahead at center is Milan Hayduk. Hayduk will circle back and wait for reinforcements. Now pushed ahead. Gets the return feed. He's got to step on Sekourash. Hayduk overskated the puck. Try to return feed to him. It's broken up. Jason Marshall gets to it for Minnesota, and he'll clear to center. Here's Morris, cross ice for Rob Blake. Blake gets center away from Walls, will shoot in. Schultz is on. He's hit the big way by Tanguay. Here's Forsberg now. He and Tanguay come together. Mitchell finishes his check. That's got to be some of the Minnesota strategy. Shot from Morris. Stick save from Rolison. Put some wear and tear on this Forsberg line. In the event if it's a long series, make them pay for every time they've got the puck.
Their goal was to stay in his face, get as close to Peter as possible. Their thinking is that between Darby Hendrickson, Loxonen, obviously Wes Walls is the centerman that goes head-to-head with him more than any other centerman on Minnesota. Get close to him, get in his face, get him involved in physical activity. Well, right now, the Forsberg line has dominated play early on in this hockey game.
And again, who haven't they dominated play?
Right.
It's all season.
Exactly right.
Certainly in the last 2 months, flat-out genius
Here's Battaglia on the backhand. A second to the forehand. Roberson the save.
I guess this is the classic weathering the storm by the home team in the first game of the playoffs. Wow.
You got that right. And you need, that's why goaltending is everything come postseason. So far, Roberson has been very, very strong. Very calm, very comfortable in goal for the Wild.
Midway point of the first period. For the time being, Colorado has had it every way they would want, except on the scoreboard, we remain scoreless.
Well, Joe Sakic's a player that certainly there's tremendous pressure on all great players. This one went right off the face of Dwayne Roberson. Snapshot, perfect setup there. A little pick to the high part of the faceoff circle. That allows Joe to get into a better angle right at the faceoff dot and let that one rip.
Any surprise on your part that it is Roberson? It was just officially determined yesterday, but really they've almost split goaltending. Two number one goalies, Manny Fernandez, and who knows who we'll see in game two.
No, I would have picked Dwayne Roberson if I was in Jacques Lemaire's position. That's not saying that Manny hasn't had a great year, but down the stretch, I think Dwayne Roberson has showed just a little bit more in terms of, not leadership, but in terms of composure in that net.
9:35 to play in the first. It's a fresh-faced Minnesota Wild team hanging tough in their first ever playoff game.
ESPN HD. Sponsored by Phillips and Best Buy.
Hey, Prima Cock! Get off the ice! It's more like Prima Donna Cock!
Hey, does anybody know the Russian word for loser?
It's Prima Cock!
Ladies and gentlemen, visiting from Western Russia, the parents of right-winger Alex Primakov.
Want to get away? Now you can. Fly Southwest Airlines with fun fares as low as $49 each way.
You are now free to move about the country.
Hello?
Hey, how you doing? You want to grab some dinner?
Oh, it's you. You don't call for ages, and I'm just supposed to say, hi, great, dinner, fine.
No, yeah, but
I... But nothing. Did you hibernate or something?
Whoa.
Hey, let's go around.
Shh. Yeah.
Look up, see blue. Labatt Blue.
You must be so hungry.
Oh, yeah.
Progressing just as you would hope, the Minnesota Wild keep getting better each and every season. Took a giant step this season from 12th in the West to the 6th seed in the Western Conference. Halfway through the season, they were 10 games over 500 and holding down the 4th spot in the West. It's amazing how things can change. That was about the same point Colorado was fighting to hang on for the 8th spot. It was a brilliant second half for Colorado that got them their record 9th division title. And I guess you can say what you want about the division they play in, but I don't care. 9 consecutive division title wins. Simply phenomenal.
Well, and more importantly, it's about momentum gained versus momentum lost. I'm really interested to see how the Vancouver Canucks come out for game one, because they clearly lost a ton of momentum down the stretch.
Cross ice pass. Chip towards the front of the net. Schultz is there. He partially fanned on his clear. Yes, Sapango, I have a question for you. Isn't this supposed to be the Blues against the Avalanche here? I keep looking for Chris Osgood.
And something got fouled up along the way. We had that matchup ready for a month and a half.
That was in cement, folks. That was done deal. Until the final day of the regular season. Kind of whack. In across the line. Here's Forsberg. Tricky drop pass. Three shot. Rolls to the save. Stop Tenge on the rebound. And finally the whistle.
Oh, there's Forsberg jumping in after the whistle had gone, and you've got to love Peter for that type of character that he brings to the table. After the whistle, a little skirmish involved. Forsberg's drop pass right on the tape to the defenseman, Greg DeVries. Tanguay's already in front of the net, causing a screen, maybe a slight deflection. And after this here, this shot and the save, the rebound there is Crowd. The right leg gets down low and a little hit from behind by Schultz. And that is why Peter Forsberg jumped in to help his left winger.
Sakic thrown out of the faceoff.
One goal in his last 10 games.
Richard Park trying to move it away. Park one on two, trying to beat Martin Skula. Sakic trying to push it up the far side. There was some question whether Skula would play in this game tonight. As Reinbrecht gets to it for Colorado. Skula missed the season finale. Bruised shoulder. He had played 285 consecutive games. Robeson gets back in. He was sort of swung around by Battaglia. Well behind the play. Paul Dvorsky was there the whole time to watch.
Well, Rollison got a little bit of help from his defenseman right in front of the net. I think it was Sekeras that blocked that shot as it was going in on the empty net. Whether or not it was targeted for between the pipes or not, it was close.
On the far side. Wild able to get to it. 7.5 to go. Scoreless first. It's been all Colorado. Nothing to show for it. Far side. Schultz kept in momentarily. Here's Aubin. Has Nick Schultz left the ice yet?
No, he has played a ton. He and Zuzan have been paired up here on this shift, but to begin it, he was with Willie Mitchell.
Centering pass broken up. Heino out there with Wilsey and Aubin. Aubin's had a couple of pretty good shifts early on here. Ronning trying to get to it. Can't get it out. Heino to go for a change, but he made the play to force the action deeper. Schultz gets to it again for Minnesota. Play out at center. Sakic on a back check. And it's picked up by Marchman off the glass into the Minnesota end. Lubomir Sekeras is back for it. Chance was taken down. We've yet to have a penalty in the game. That's good news all around.
These are two very disciplined clubs. The Colorado Avalanche tied for 7th, Minnesota 6th.
And it's cleared out to center. 6:25 to play here in the first ever Stanley Cup playoff game in the young history of the Minnesota Wild. They've been clearly outplayed, but it remains scoreless. Jason Marshall might have gotten away with a hit from behind there. I think he leveled Eric Messier of Colorado. Foot will slow things down back behind his net. Welcome those of you that are watching the Detroit-Anaheim game as they head for overtime. While they're in intermission, enjoy the Avs in the Wild. Here's DeVries, has a lane, wrist shot, tipped. Never made it on goal, off the glass. Wrapped around by Kuba, far side. Lake able to keep in, here's Forsberg. Back to the net, trying to sneak a little centering pass. And it was broken up. Kuba will push it across, and it's tipped out to center ice. Now, he played some 15 minutes. I mean, I'd have to say 12 of them have played, been played in the Minnesota and maybe 3 all together in the Colorado.
No, I agree with you 100%. The ice has been tilted so far, and we anticipated that it was going to take some time for Minnesota to get, you know, gather their thoughts and make sure they make, you know, get right decisions going. We have yet to see the Minnesota Wild that we saw in the regular season early in this hockey game.
Here's Brunette back behind the net. Brunette turned around, had the lane, couldn't get the shot away as the net was nearly knocked over. One of the better chances so far for Minnesota. Brunette looked like he had a clear path to it. Johnson and Marchment locked up in a pretty good battle in front of that Colorado end. Good check throw there. Bodies are starting to fly, folks. Zuzan and Battaglia involved. Here's Bates Battaglia the other way. And he centered. Only Zuzan there for Minnesota. Brunette will get to it and shoot in. Shots are 15-3 Colorado. Scoring chances are 12-3 Colorado to this point.
Hale Rowley the goalie.
And yet we're scoreless. At center now. Tipped ahead by Richard Park. Back forward is Martin Skula. And he'll flip it out to center. Softly, but not soft enough. Icing will be called.
The Wild have their first best chance. And it's the veteran, Andrew Brunette. 4 goals in his last 20. Looking for his 5th, but denied.
Live around.
new Silverado is here, now with quadrasteer four-wheel steering. It's the most maneuverable full-size pickup you can get. Silverado, the truck.
Explore Magrak today. It's not on satellite TV, it's on Insight Digital Cable. From Harleys to Hondas, Motorcycle Freedom puts you on the road with the world's hottest bikes. And uncork the secrets of winning wines on Wine World. Magrak has dozens of video magazines made just for you. Start them anytime, even pause, rewind, and fast forward. Best of all, with Insight Digital Cable, you get Magrak at no extra charge. Call today.
Hi, I'm James Brown from the NFL on Fox, and I'm proud to be a March of Dimes volunteer. Premature birth is a bigger problem in this country than most people think. It affects one of every eight babies. Now, some of these babies are born so early that doctors can't save them. Others may suffer lifelong consequences like mental retardation and blindness. You can help the March of Dimes fight prematurity. Sign up for Walk America. Visit walkamerica.org or call 1-800-525-WALK.
Back in Denver, Minnesota, looking for a sweep in the college hockey game prior to us here on ESPN2. Minnesota with a stunning overtime win to beat Michigan. So the Golden Gophers advance to the finals for the NCAA championship. Game's being played in Buffalo. We've seen on ESPN and ESPN2. They love their college hockey. Hey, they love their high school hockey in Minnesota. Talk about the state of hockey. That's Minnesota. Detroit has Hockey Town. Minnesota calls themselves the state of hockey. Coming up, the Southwest Intermission Report. That's coming up next. John and Ray will have highlights of the Ducks and the Red Wings, the Capitals and the Lightning, and a special edition of PTI. Pardon the interruption. All coming up on the Southwest Airlines Intermission Report.
Steve, on January 16th, Tony Granato's squad was 13 points behind Vancouver, but won 25 of their last 37 games to win the division title. Is that something? And every time we talk to Tony Granato, who last year at this time was working at the Xcel Energy Center doing college hockey on ESPN.
Here's Hendrickson, little drop pass. And the Avs get to Bates Battaglia.
But he just appears so confident, so self-assured. And that's the way he played as an athlete, and that's what I've admired about him now.
Turnover to Sakic, and he missed it from close quarters. Put it right through the crease on the far side, and it goes into the first row. We send it back to John Buchegras.
Steve, many wondered if Michael Nylander would be a playoff performer after his fine regular season. Well, he gets his first playoff goal in 19 games. Two for Robert Lang. Shut up, only the goalie. Game one, win, Capitals.
How's that home ice advantage working out? Not so good so far.
That's a tough one, though. Those two teams are so close, you know?
Best way to follow the action of every NHL game, NHL Gamecast. NHL Gamecast provides fans with live scoring, shot charts, and game stats. NHL Gamecast, available on ESPN.com. Heavy shot by Blake on Rollison. Not the first time Dwayne Rollison has stopped the Rob Blake shot. The two natives of Simcoe, Ontario, grew up playing hockey together. Ronan can't get to it, and it's lost out to center ice. Shot softly in. Wye will slow it down for Rob Blake. Hey, we mentioned PTI. See what Michael Wilbon was wearing on?
I saw that.
I don't know.
That might have been a 69-70 Stan Mikita-style sweatsuit, but that was fabulous. I know he's a Chicago native, and nice to see the old Indian head up there on somebody's body.
Blackhawks aren't, they're not in the postseason again, I think, right, Clarence?
No. I'm not doing any home games this season. I'm very disappointed about that. I'm sure they are, too.
Back behind the net now. Here's Messier on it. He's checked by Zuzan. Joltok comes over to help out. Park will play it off the boards. He'll go all the way across for Cliff Ronning. Trying to thread the needle. Could not. Picked off by Skula of Colorado. Here's Martin Skula across the line. He's slowed down by Jim Dowd. Five players make it 6 along the wall. We'll get the whistle. Minute 41 left in a scoreless first.
We talked to Dwayne Rolison about the prospects of facing Peter Forsberg. Here's what he had to say.
Basically, just try and go out and, you know, just concentrate on the puck. You know, the puck's the one that's got to beat me. It's not his body movement. And as a goalie, that's all you got to do is worry about the puck, and hopefully I'll be able to concentrate on it enough to be able to stop him.
Rolison stopped that one. So how did the Wild clinch a playoff spot? Rolison was in goal on March 23rd. How'd they get in? A shutout of mighty Detroit to clinch their playoff spot.
Oh. I mean, Rolison has been a rock, and he's been rewarded with a new 3-year contract. This is the guy that a couple of years ago was in the minor leagues. He fought through it. He battled adversity. He hung with the program. And now he's going to make nearly $2 million a year. And with incentives, it could bring him to $2.5 to $3 million.
You look at his transaction list for Rolison. Free agent, free agent, free agent. Every single time, foot was cruising through looking for the tip. Rolison was out of position that time. Here's Sakic on it. Sakic's had a strong period. Nothing to show for it. Really, you could say that about every member of the Avalanche. And here's Foot lining up. 63 ticks left in period number one. Rolison will put it off the glass. Well, might have caught the netting, but it stays in play.
Yeah, don't forget, Dwayne has to switch hands, and he plays it to his backhand a lot.
Tenge tried the fancy move, can't get through the Minnesota defense. Forsberg can, though. Here's Forsberg back behind the net. Hits the brakes. Mitchell over to check him. And Walls gets to it. Rolls up to the point, though. There's Blake. Pass Forsberg finds Tenge. Heyduk is sniffing around the net. All three forwards are pinned behind the net. Forsberg was dumped in a big way, looking for a call. Won't get one. We're on the verge of a penalty-free period. Here's Jason Marshall, hit by Morris. Shoots it back behind the net. Headman pass for Tenge, the onside to make the move, and could not get around the Wild defense led by Philippe Kuba.
Wow, you talk about closing the gap. Good play by Kuba. Good defensive play by Wes Walls behind the net before that. With the two abs down behind the net, he got the puck and got the transition game going.
After 20 minutes of play, the first ever Wild playoff game, we are scoreless. The shots are 18-3 in favor of the Avalanche. Neither team has anything to show for it. John and Ray on the other side.
Okay, let's do it.
First up, surveillance cams. Laser grid next. Now, the tough one. The floor is heat sensitive.
Re-engineered degree for men. An extra kick of protection. Every time you need it.
This is too easy.
Oh, one more thing. Attack dogs.
New degree for men kicks in the clutch.
I'll take Chris.
Okay. Okay. I'll take Chris's buddy. You playing that?
Why not?
Look up, see blue. Look back blue.
Steve-o. Good hands.
Oh, thanks. Instinct.
These are America's mean streets, where the truth is heard. And now there's a new rapper in town, a plain white rapper.
Y'all got guns, makes me wanna run. I ain't having no fun. I feel like I'm a hot dog and y'all be the bun.
Jamie Kennedy, Tay Diggs, Anthony Anderson, Regina Hall, and Snoop Dogg.
Stuart Little? That little white rat ain't got nothing on me. Pound it.
Malibu's Most Wanted, rated PG-13.
I'm Tim.
Starts April 18th.
Hi. We have a little leak or something. Holy moly. Guess I better get started.
Right. But first, could you give me your price and the prices of some of your competitors?
You know, don't want to pay too much.
Hey! Our customers know the importance of shopping around. Because at Progressive.com, you can get our price for car insurance, plus the rates of other big-name companies. You could save hundreds. Call Progressive today.
Papa John's. After 19 years, no question. It's an amazing pizza.
Celebrate Papa John's 19th anniversary. Get two large one-topping pizzas for just $11.99. Call us now. We'll be right there.
Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's.
Welcome to the Southwest Airlines Intermission Report.
With Ray Farrar, I'm John Butchergrass. Night two of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Other games going on right now in Detroit. And much like the Wild and Avalanche, the Ducks, a prohibitive underdog against the defending Stanley Cup champions. And holy shnikey, what is that?
That's a beautiful octopus, John.
First period, no score. Detroit power play. That's easy. Tommy Holmstrom, Brendan Shanahan.
Keith Carney gets caught looking at the puck. Turns the wrong way. The puck goes through the crease. Easy one for Shanahan.
Back come the Ducks. Kurt Sauer shot, save, and squirts right to Adam Oates. 1-1 after the first, and that's it. No more goals.
No, I've been good goaltending in this game. Both guys have played very well.
Four of the nine playoff games between Detroit and Anaheim have gone to overtime. Detroit has won them all. Okay. Tampa Bay, Washington. First period, no score. Mike Greer and Robert Lang out of midair, Ray.
They must play baseball in the Czech Republic. It goes up in the air here. Lang gets pretty good wood on it and beats Hobby Boulin over the glove.
Second period, Vinny LeCavalier gets the pass, and holy, wow. Flexibility strong. Third period now, Sergei Gonchar, the tragically Kit Miller to Michael Nylander. First playoff goal in his career in his 19th game, and what Mark Hoppus is to Blink 182. Ole, the goalie, is to the Capitals. 28 saves, sixth career playoff shutout. Two goals for Lang, one for Nylander, and the Capitals lead the series. One game to none. After 20 minutes in Denver, the Minnesota Wild survive so far 0-0. More after this.
This intermission report, presented by Southwest Airlines, the official airline of the National Hockey League.
Some people don't realize how many nonstop flights Southwest offers, so we created this simple color-coded map to help. Baltimore to L.A. is red. Phoenix to Raleigh-Durham, blue. Chicago to Seattle, yellow. L.A. to Austin, canary yellow. Orlando to Albuquerque, teal. Las Vegas to Houston, aquamarine. Buffalo to Phoenix, beige umber. San Jose to Baltimore, pistachio. Oakland to Chicago, sea green. Albany to Orlando, puce. Tampa to St. Louis, pinkish. New Orleans to San Diego, kinda green.
You are now free to move about the country.
Okay. I'll take Chris's buddy. You playing that?
Why not?
Look up, see blue. Look back blue.
Play ball. Strike three, here. Safe.
Rated E for everyone.
Nervous about foot odor and wetness? Get Odor Eater's foot powder and kick the problem. Odor Eater's powder gives protection on demand, even kicks out heavy duty odor and sweat.
Of all who threaten it. Navy, accelerate your life. Call 1-800-USA-NAVY.
K-Swiss. Here we go, y'all.
Go, y'all.
Part two. Got love for my shoes, K-Swiss. Let me introduce the K-Swiss Nito. You can rock anywhere, anytime that you'll be seen, yo. With a flip of the wrist and a twist, you get a whole new vibe from K-Swiss that I'll never miss. Classic style with a new school twist. Got love for my shoes, K-Swiss. Got love for my shoes, K-Swiss.
Welcome back to the Southwest Airlines Intermission Report.
We now have five playoff games in the books, and the lower seed is now 4-1. Michael Wilbaugh and Tony Kornheiser from PTI give us their reasons why upsets can happen at any time in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Okay, Wilbon, let's talk hockey, and let's start with hockey fashion. What on earth are you wearing?
You don't know?
No, I do
not know. It's a 1969-70 warm-up sweater worn by Tony Esposito, who in his rookie year had 15 shutouts. Anybody in New York, your city, your hometown, ever had 15 shutouts as a rookie?
Eddie Jockman,
or any other
maybe,
year?
Chico
no,
Resch, maybe.
No, you know? Esposito was the only one
okay,
to do
it. Okay, if he's so great, Marty Turco broke his record this year
sadly.
For goals against average. So does that mean, if you like goalies so much, does that mean you think Dallas will win the Cup?
I like goaltending that much. And the reason, yeah, I do. I think Dallas will win. I wouldn't argue, but I'd tell you what, Dallas won't be playing Ottawa in the first round. You know why? In the finals, you know why?
Why?
Because the number one seeds have only faced each other one time in the last 13 years. There are more upsets. There are more 8-1 upsets in the NHL.
Do you have
other sports wouldn't
you have
consider
a theory
that possible.
Why has that happened?
Goaltending. It is so disproportionately important that you can take a number 8 seed, a number 7 seed playing a number 2 team, and you can have a great goaltender in a zone
okay,
in
but
and
why,
go all
why
the way.
Why wouldn't the number 1 team have a great goaltender considering they got
maybe
all the way to be number 1?
Maybe the regular season. Maybe number 1 goaltenders will have to play that,
that
well in the regular
to do with
season.
The
then what's your theory,
Mr. Hockey? Your theory is idiotic. Here's why it happens. Because hockey players will tell you this. They don't care where they finish in the regular season as long as they get in. They don't believe home ice is any particular advantage. So if you finish 8th, you finish 7th, it's okay with them. They don't care.
It's okay to be playing Detroit in the first round. It's okay to be playing Dallas in the first round.
Read my
it's
lips.
Okay to be playing
it's
Ottawa.
Okay.
It's garbage.
It's, okay.
It's goaltending. Of course it's goaltending. What else would it be?
Oh, so you think
Patrick Waugh, look what happened when he finally
broke. Oh, that's right. He came up large in his own building. He stood on his head. It's all
you
goaltending.
You want to discount
you must
goaltending
know.
In the Stanley
not
Cup
discounting
playoffs.
Discounting it. I'm not saying it's everything. It couldn't be
well,
everything.
Who are you picking? You picking against Dallas?
I'm picking against the Dallas TV show. I thought it stunk. I like Knott's Landing a lot
Enough.
Better.
Enough. We're done here. Back to you.
Is it all goaltending? You've played on teams who've pulled off upsets.
Yeah, and I've played on teams that have had no luck in goal either. And it's even though Wilbon's wearing a wonderful sweatshirt, it
boys,
is goaltending.
That boys medium?
Yeah, it is. It's snug.
Right. After 20 minutes in Denver, no score between the Wild and the Colorado Avalanche. Second period, Steve Leagy and Pang Chung tonight. Darren Pang, we return.
Are you paying too much for shipping? Priority Mail Service is dependable delivery starting at just $3.85. Maybe that's why we deliver more business packages than any two-day service. Priority Mail from the United States Postal Service.
Let's say your sister lives in town, but your brother lives on the other side of the country. A phone call to your brother should cost the same as it does to your sister, don't you think? Well, it does now. Because with the neighborhood, you get unlimited local and long distance for one low monthly price. Makes the whole country seem like a little neighborhood.
Call 1-800-JOIN-MCI today, the neighborhood, where local and long distance come together.
Elias, I have to go back to my convention. Yeah, I know, but I have a convention. Bueno.
Come on.
I have to go. My convention. I know. I wish I could stay. We got married. I have to go. I love you. I'll call you. But you know one more thing.
Yeah.
Oh, you smell.
I am Catherine, and this is my daughter, Faith. She was born almost 4 months early and had so many life-threatening problems. Faith is 7 years old now and continues to struggle with the serious long-term effects of being born prematurely. She has sight, speech, motor, and learning challenges. Help the Match of Dimes fight prematurity. Sign up for Walk America today.
I'm Susan Henderson. My daughter Emma was born 3 months early and spent 101 days in a NICU like this one. As a result, Emma has a permanent shunt in her brain and mild cerebral palsy. While our family still worries about these and other long-term effects of premature birth, Emma is a happy, energetic 7-year-old. Sadly, our story isn't unique. Too many babies are born too soon, and many never come home. Help fight prematurity. Sign up for Walk America today.
First overtime playoff game of this postseason. In overtime, the Wings for the win. Oh, Igor Larionov centering pass. Took a bad hop. I think it was either Correa or Oates in front.
Yeah, deflected off a skate, hit the goalpost. Jaguar's made several good saves already in overtime.
Cujo's been excellent as well. Still in overtime in Detroit. Don't forget, right after the Wild and Avalanche, Barry Melrose joins us for NHL Tonight scores, highlights, breakdown, review, and preview right after the game.
This intermission report, presented by Southwest Airlines, the official airline of the National Hockey League.
Enjoy the convenience of great tasting filtered water in your kitchen, in your bar, and even in your bathroom. The AquaSuite filtering faucet from Moen. Buy it for looks, buy it for life.
11 action sports, 6 world teams, 1 global title. This time, it's not personal. The X Games Global Championship, presented by Bruce Almighty, beginning May 17th on ESPN, ESPN2, and ABC Sports.
What if God granted you his power? This Memorial Day, an ordinary guy will work wonders.
Sam?
Are you ready for a miracle?
Perform miracles.
I swear my boobs are bigger.
Are you ready for a miracle?
And do unto others.
Hey, Bruce, cat got your tongue?
As they did unto him. Jim Carrey is Bruce Almighty. Rated PG-13 at theaters May 23rd.
Hey, guys.
Hey, what's up, man? Well?
Well, what?
Aren't you going to say something?
About what?
Forget it.
What's the matter?
I can't believe I changed my hair and you guys don't even notice.
You're not a woman. Why use a woman's gel? Introducing Suave for Men Sport Gel. Holds just as good as her brand for half the price. New Suave for Men.
The first major advance for the fastest treatment of athlete's foot is Lamisil AT. Lamisil AT is the first non-prescription medicine proven to kill the fungus with just 1 week's use.
Not even a prescription can beat that.
Lotrimin AF and Tenactin still expect you to treat for 4 weeks. Who's gonna do that?
When your feet itch and burn, using Lamisil AT 1 week keeps you athlete's foot free 3 months. Lamisil AT. There's no better way to cure athlete's foot.
Introducing new body wash from Old Spice.
Put my love to the test.
It has a dual action formula, so you'll get really clean, smell really great.
Hey, Ben, need help with your anatomy homework?
New body wash from Old Spice.
Tonight on a Regal Sports Center, Motown begins its defense of Lord Stanley's Cup. Could Augusta master the elements? And are the Lakers still the real kings of the NBA? Sports Center, 11 p.m. Eastern on ESPN.
The Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN2 brought to you by 1-800 call ATT for collect calls. It's free for you and cheap for them. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires. And Las Vegas, the biggest, best resorts in the world, all share the same address, only in Vegas. Back at the Pepsi Center here in Denver, Colorado, as we get set for the start of second period action. And the Shocker, the Wild, and the Avalanche are scoreless. Didn't have a single penalty in the period. Steve Levy alongside Darren Pang with plenty of shots. Colorado outshot Minnesota 18-3, and yet we're still scoreless.
If I'm Minnesota right now, I'm feeling good about the fact it's a 0-0 hockey game. I'm not happy with our lack of composure inside our own zone. The one thing you got to keep in mind is that the Avalanche defensemen continue to get quality scoring chances. Between Rob Blake and Greg DeVries, that's five shots there. Although there's plenty of pressure on Dwayne Rolison, we'll take a look at Battaglia had a shot. There's one good example from Rob Blake. Rebound to Sakic. Forsberg, that was his only shot of the period. In the meantime, he set up a few gems. And you see the movement of Dwayne Rolison on top of his crease. Dwayne Rolison likes to talk about the toes of his skates pointing north towards the shooter. I would have to say that he gets an A-plus in terms of technical positioning in that opening 20 minutes of play.
You know, by my count, actually it was by Ben's count,
okay,
12 different Avalanche players had shots on goal in that first period. I wonder if that ice is a little worn down at that end now after switching ends to open up period number two. Hey, that trivia question, who scored the first wild playoff game in playoff goal in franchise history? Still out there. Still out there. Who's it going to be? I bet there folks in Minnesota have got a pool going that way. Who will it be? The answer to a trivia question. Here's DeVries. Wraps it around far side off Battaglia and skips out to center. Zuzin will get to it. And backtracking his own end away from Reinprecht. Foot will shoot in soft. Liam Zuzin will get another crack at it. Forsberg will forecheck on him. Wild turn it over right at the blue line. Forsberg's got a step and he's got the puck on Zuzin. Here's Forsberg trying to power by Zuzin and can't. Now he does. Second chance, trying to wrap around. And it was stopped by Rolison. We pick off the same way we left off. Here's Forsberg. Tange was skating backwards, reaching for it. Back to Blake. He'll go across for the one-time shot and a save. Morris got the shot away. Cleared the center now. Dupuis will shoot it. Roy will swing it around. And up to center. Here's Hayduke will let the shot go. It was blocked. Never made it on goal. Out at center, turned over to Blake. He'll take a bump, clips in. Rosie on the forecheck there. Bouncing puck, loose to Minnesota. And the Wild look to break the center. Find themselves two on two and in desperate need of a line change. He'll peel off. Matt Johnson fanned on his shot. Wilsey will pick up the loose puck. Wilsey will shoot it and look for the count. Aubin is there with Schultz. Heinold in on the forecheck. Marchment will get to it. Calm things down. Bit of a better start to the period for Minnesota. Certainly better than what happened in the first period.
Boy, they were out early, too, to begin the period. They were out, and it must have been 30 or 40 seconds. Nobody at the other end of the ice. Finally, the Avalanche came out onto the ice, so obviously Minnesota got some talking to, and they were chomping at the bit to get out here.
Back behind the net. And now Park will get to it. Dowd goes behind the net. I can't find him, not for the time being. Here's Sekeras, the defenseman in deep. Finds Park. Quick shot is deflected. Good shot block there by Skula. Park gets to it. Now penalty coming up. And I believe it's going to go against Brunette and Minnesota.
First power play of the game. And it will go to the Colorado Avalanche. And it's not as if they need any more
degrees,
momentum.
A minor penalty, 2 minutes hooking.
As we hear the call from the veteran referee. Little hook right there. So we take a look at the power play all season long for Colorado, ranked sixth in the NHL. As Brunette's going to go off. The stick got caught in the right shoulder of Brian Marchman. He can't believe it. But the stick was up high, and obviously Marchman helped out by maybe yanking a little bit. But Brunette gets called for hooking, and they'll go up against the fifth-ranked road penalty killing unit in the NHL. The Wild were at 86% on the road.
Here's a Forsberg line now on the power play. Tange's in a high slot. Work back to the point. Morris. Blake will play to the other side. Hayduk shot. And a save by Rolison. Sarafi, what a stop that was by Rolison as well. Here's Forsberg on the loose puck now. One-timer's fanned on. Morris will shoot it off for Hayduk. He finds Forsberg now. Forsberg top of the circle. Driving a backdoor, got it through. Blake in front of it. It's scrambled for it. And it just rolled to the crease and wide. And Morris trying to hold it in. Able to do
so. Here's Forsberg, turns it over, and Walls will get to it and clear.
Wow, great pressure, and again, Dwayne Rollison withstands the constant bombardment that he's facing right now. And you have to wonder, with the high altitude, how tiring this is on the old lungs there, as far as Rollison's concerned.
You know, 20 years from now, Panga, when I ask you who took the first Minnesota Wild penalty in Stanley Cup playoff history...
Well, you'll always have that answer.
Andrew Brunette at 254 for hooking. I guess you've had enough of the Trivial Pursuit game, huh?
Not very good at it, but...
I would think with hockey you'd be excellent at it.
Good Canadian guys invented that game and became very wealthy because of it.
Is that true?
Yep. That's out of play there. It's so the faceoff will be inside the blue line. Oh boy, Rolly, you've been marvelous. Forsberg's shot here, hit the stick of the Wild player Walls. Blake has got his big body right in front of the net. Now it's a scramble. This one was poked wide. Hayduke went in on the back end from our Southwest Airlines goal cam. Hayduke's gonna poke at it. Oh, just wide. Willie Mitchell's looking at that puck, and it had to have been, what, half a foot wide on the far side.
Here's Blake on it now. Got it away. Rollison, the sliding save. Penalty coming up. Penalty coming up. We're going to be all even. Hayduke, I believe, pulled his man down. Was it Tanguay? Pulled down Willie Mitchell. And we're going to be even up for 16
Tanguay,
seconds.
2 minutes for Holland.
In fact, it is Tanguay. Thank you, Paul DeBorski.
Yeah, you bet. The one was a hook on Brunette. This one's a hold. Let's see him reach out with that left arm. And once you let go of your stick and haul somebody down, whether or not that player helped out a little bit, the referee was not 5 feet from him. So it's a good call, and Tanguay goes off, nullifying the power play for the Avalanche. And in 16 seconds, the Minnesota Wild will have the man advantage.
4:38 is the time of the penalty. There's Tony Granato, cool and calm, coaching in his first ever playoff game. In fact, we've got five different first-time NHL coaches in Stanley Cup playoff action today, tonight, throughout the NHL. Your buddy Bruce Cassidy off to a pretty good start. Congratulations to him.
That's that old Ottawa 67 flavor he's throwing in there.
Road shutout, first time out. Take that.
Maybe it is easier starting out on the road. Less pressure, simplify your game.
Power play now underway for 90 seconds, and we'll see what the Wild can do with it. Here's Philippe Kuba, their top scoring defenseman. Him and Sekerash play the points on this Minnesota power play. Sekerash is in deep. Here's Brunette. Brunette's got a second crack at it. Brunette for Joltok. Joltok gets a second chance. Here's Brunette. Top of back door shot, score! It's Kuba sneaking in from the point position. And there's the answer to your trivia question. It's going to be Philippe Kuba, a power play goal, and Minnesota leads 1-0.
Boy, weak side D jumping into the play. An outstanding play. For the first time in this game, we've seen Minnesota have calmness with the puck, taking their time, nice patience, and setting it up. And it does help that they're on the power play. The key is Brunette, 15 on your right side. He's going to feather a little pass over a stick right on the tape, and he's waiting for Kuba to come in from the right point. But from a reverse angle, keep your eye on the bottom part of your screen to the right. He's a left-hand shot, and that's the big key right there. He's able to be on his strong side, and he's got his body in perfect position. Do not underestimate the outstanding pass from Andrew Brunette. Right on the tape.
And Patrick really got over there in a hurry. Did not give Kuba a lot to shoot at. And the Minnesota Wild, a 1-0 lead on a power play goal, the Tanguay penalty, really smart. Here's Hendrickson, all of a sudden the lane opens up for him. Drop pass, here come the Wild, shot to save. Zuzan got the shot away, and Roy had to go post to post to make another pretty good save. And Minnesota has come on. For Philippe Kuba, it is first career playoff goal. It's a power play goal. Brunette and Joltok will get it at 5:33. Totally dominated, getting Minnesota the 1-0 lead.
Smith, you get a raise?
No, I got an Optima.
Introducing the Kia Optima midsize sedan.
Smith got a raise and options.
With available V6.
VP?
10-year, 100,000-mile warranty.
Smith's taking over.
Smith. and a starting price around $16,000.
Watch your back, Smith.
Smith Worldwide.
It'll just look like you got a raise. The Kia Optima. Right now, get 0% financing or up to $3,000 cash back.
Word has it someone here is trying to make a collect call. Calm down, people. All you got to do is dial down the center with 1-800-C-A-L-L-A-T-T. It's free for you, cheap for them. What do you say we get up out here and go hit a disco? Or not.
Save on every call. Dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
Michelin designed the cross-terrain SUV tires specifically for SUVs to help provide responsive handling and a smooth ride. You'd be surprised just how smooth. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
Philippe Kuba is on the board, has given the Wild the 1-0 lead. And when Minnesota leads, wow, during a regular season, an 875 win percentage when scoring first, the best in the National Hockey League. Shots are 22-6 Colorado, but the only thing that matters is the 1-0 Wild lead right now.
That's for sure.
Second period's been a good one, though, for the Avs as well. Keep that in mind. Minnesota's even, and in terms of goals for and goals against, Colorado is plus 19.
At what point does Colorado get really frustrated, Panga, that they totally dominated play and have yet to even score a goal, find themselves trailing now?
You just keep going. Your mindset is keep doing the things you're doing. They scored on a power play. At even strength, you're dominating play, and eventually you're going to get one. You have to believe that.
Rolison had some problems with that, but he'll hang on. Minnesota's confidence growing now with every second.
Let's go back to the goal that was scored here. As the Minnesota Wild work it on one side, we're going to freeze it at one point. Keep her going. There. Stop it here, guys. Everybody's looking here. Now, the key guy is Kuba, who jumps in from the weak side. Let it roll. Perfect pass right on the tape. None of the Avs can get over there in time, including Patrick, who got there quickly, as you mentioned, just not quick enough for Kuba, who had two goals in his last 20 regular season games.
Kuba led the team in ice this season. He's led Minnesota in average ice time all three seasons in franchise history. Shot, stop, and the rebound just shot wide. Rolison got the first one. But Taglia's shot from the corner is stopped by Rolison, and he'll hang on to that one. And we will send it back to John Butchergrass.
Overtime in Detroit. Detroit has lost their last five playoff home games in overtime. Luke Robitaille to win. Red light comes on. The crowd goes wild, but you can see on the review, it did not go in. Detroit on the power play now in overtime. Still 1-1.
John, thank you. Keep us posted. The best way to follow the action of every NHL game is NHL Gamecast. NHL Gamecast provides fans with live scoring, shot charts, and game stats. NHL Gamecast available on ESPN.com as well as NHL.com. Pushed out to center ice. Look at the shots. 24-6 in favor of Colorado. The Avs trailing 1-0. Imagine those watching in Minneapolis, St. Paul, the Twin Cities, they're going wild.
A lot of them are at the XL Energy Center.
Yep.
Combination. Finish watching the college game and watching the Wild play. First shot on goal there for Marian Gabbert. One from the outside as he continues to play with Antti Laaksonen and Wes Walls.
One touch to down and across the line. Down lets it go. The save by Walls. And he'll hang on. Since an NHL franchise from Minnesota has won a playoff game.
It sure has been, and you've got to go to the old Minnesota North Stars. And, of course, Bob Gainey was the head coach in the 92 Norris Division Final up against the Detroit Red Wings. Brian Bellows with the shot, and he scores on Tim Cheveldae, the veteran Bobby Smith alongside as well. And the place at the Met was just jumping in Bloomington, Minneapolis. And that was some building. I played my first NHL game there, but nothing like the building that they have now in St. Paul.
It is a spectacular facility.
Last time Minnesota won a playoff series was back in 91. Western Conference Finals beat Edmonton, only to lose to Pittsburgh in the Stanley Cup Finals.
And of course, they lost against the Red Wings in Game 6 and 7 to lose that series.
Brunette came out of the corner, was wrecked by Morris, got the shot away, but it was wide. He was on the backhand. Minnesota bodies are going down left and right. No penalties called. Eric Messier went down to block that shot. There is a delay penalty coming up. Messier went down again. He's got no other choices without a stick. Delayed penalty against Colorado. Extra attacker on for Minnesota. Here's Zsolta. Goes across ice. Brunette's parked in front of the net. Brad Brown to the front of the net as well. Cross. Here's Zsolta holding. Parker jumps on the ice now to finish his check. That shot is deflected off the glass. Parker touches it now. And that's the whistle. And another Minnesota power play upcoming.
Interference call, and Parker took his frustrations out on a big hit on the far side. And
then a minor penalty on 27 White for interference.
And then he fired the puck up over the in the stands. And that's an area that you got to wonder why they don't call that delay of game. But Parker ends up getting an interference call. You got to give credit to the Minnesota Wild. I mean, they were jumping. There's the call on Brad Brown, a defenseman, again for the Wild. Once the Wild cycle down low, then their defensemen jump in. And I tell you, Rob Blake said that to me today. He said, don't underestimate their defensemen. They join the plays, not as much as we do, but close.
Try to center for Park. Couldn't get the shot away. Zsolta has the puck. Park again. Drop pass, Ronning, let it go. Save, rebound, score! Marion Gaborik on the far side. Ron got a piece, but not enough. And don't look now. Another power play goal, make it 2-0 Minnesota.
Couple of broken down plays, and this will be big for Marion Gaborik, the 6'1", 185-pound native of Slovakia. Only had 3 goals in his last 20 games. Richard Park made a decision to go back to the point. It ends up being a great decision. Gabrick's got the rebound, foot can't get to him, and it went between the wickets as Patrick Waugh was leaning to his left. If that goes to the near corner, Patrick gets it. Instead, he went through the legs to the opposite corner. So good instincts there by Gabrick.
Likely the first of many for that young superstar to be, if he's not already there. Marion Gaborik has given Minnesota a 2-0 lead and taken the crowd out of this game. How do you like that Wild power play, Packer? They're now 2-for-2 with 3 shots on goal and scored on 2 of the 3 shots. And they're looking for more. Shot, score! It's in again! Pasquale Dupuis set it up! And it's a 3-0 Minnesota lead.
A stunned Avalanche bench. Wes Wallace on the doorstep. Pasquale Dupuis as head coach Jacques Lemaire tinkers with the lines. Marshall on the forecheck, the veteran forward, used to be a defenseman, gets rewarded for his hard work, and he's in the lineup. Dupuis, backhand attempt, the rebound was right there, and that's where Wes Wallace jumps in from the left side of our screen. He's a right-hand shot. He was a natural goal scorer wherever he played junior hockey, drafted in the first round, and now he's a defensive player, but you don't lose the offensive instincts.
Foot will shoot it around the far side. Down will get to it. As far as tonight goes, shots on goal is the most overrated statistic in this playoff. 3-0 Minnesota Wild. Foot will get to it. Shot never got on goal. For Wes Walls, it is his first Stanley Cup playoff goal since 94, but he's a member of the Flames. Waz got that one, and Eli and I hang on as Loxonen was cruising in. What is going on in Denver? 3-0 Wild.
The X Games Global Championship, coming in May on ESPN.
Yes, I have to go back to my convention.
No,
yeah, I know, but I have a convention.
Bueno?
Come on. I have to go to my convention. I know. I wish I could stay. We got married. I have to go. I love you. I'll call you. But you know one more thing.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, you smell so good, huh?
Outside and play in the mud.
Follow your heart.
Guess some things never change.
Kind of
head for the mountains of Bush.
Jason Marshall was a part of that last goal. You have to love Jacques Lemaire putting Marshall and Matt Johnson into the lineup, rewarding them for their dedication and hard work and being veterans. And sitting out the young fella, Bouchard. Let Bouchard learn, make sure he goes into a positive environment. And sure enough, that type of philosophy is paying off in dividends for the Wild and the decisions by Jacques Lemaire.
Ryan Preps, shot was blocked. You mentioned Marshall, a part of that goal. It'll read Walls, his fourth career playoff goal. But again, his first since 94 as he was a member of the Flames. Dupuis and Marshall, the helpers, at 9:53. Two goals in a 25-second span for the Wild. That's the first of the even strength goal for Minnesota. Gavrik's on the power play was from Rodding and Joltok at 9:28. Here's Marchman in deep, trying to set it. Turnaround shot, Rollison stopped it on Milan Hajduk. Wow, we'll play it.
Been a tough game for Patrick, only because he hasn't had a chance to dominate. Dwayne Rollison has done that at the other end. He has not had any momentum at all.
And across the line, here's Foote. He's in deep. Forsberg took a pretty good bump and goes down. Forsberg trying to draw a penalty there.
Yeah, referee identified that.
And none coming.
Yeah.
And now Forsberg, a cross-check to the back of Willie Mitchell.
Willie Mitchell's been on the ice for nearly every even strength shift against Forsberg.
Forsberg again banging bodies. Taken away and Dupuis will clear. That's center now. Here's Blake. Brian Wilson. Wilson across for Hino. Off and back behind the net. He's checked by Hendrickson now. Offhand fights through it, swings it to Rossi. Glove save there by Rollison, and it's clear.
Now we'll see if Colorado can regroup here. And this is the defensive structure of the Minnesota Wild that makes it so tough to break out in. And they're starting to feel a little bit more comfortable here now. Obviously, they got a three-goal lead, but they're starting to play their game now.
Here's Brunette. Off for Hendrickson, one of a handful of Minnesota natives on this Wild roster. Here's Skula from Waugh, up the near side, and all the way down. Icing will be called. Mitchell is back for the touch. Tomorrow night, the Stanley Cup playoffs roll on. It's an ESPN2 doubleheader beginning at 7 Eastern and 4 Pacific. Jeremy Roenick and the Flyers look to even up their series with the Maple Leafs. Mike Modano and the Stars will look to do likewise against the Oilers. That's the late game, 10 Eastern. That's tomorrow night, right here on ESPN2. How much do we love the late games and doubleheaders during the playoffs?
Yeah, now we get to go out after our game and watch the next. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that. We were all at the ESPN Zone, downtown Denver, watching all the games last night.
Did a nice job. How about the ribs, Ben, there at the ESPN Zone?
Ribs are good, real good.
Here's Ryan Preck. Second shot, score! Joe Sakic! And the Avalanche are on the board. It's 3-1.
Well, that's vintage Joe. And it's got the crowd alive and hopping right here in Denver. Sakic got his body down. Paglia took the pass, played it over to Ryan Preck. Ryan Preck put it right on the tape. Not quite, a little bit ahead of him. See the way Joe had to get down low, much like you see a Brett Hull get down, because the pass wasn't perfect. He made it perfect. Oh, boy, no chance for Rollison. Super play by Ryan Preck. And Joe Sakic, who had only one goal in his last 10 games, and it was in the last regular season game against the Blues. Good time for this one.
Hey, we know the Avalanche made of championship kind of fibers. We're about to find out what the Minnesota Wild are all about now. It's nice when you get a 3-0 lead, but now it's 3-1. The crowd's back into it, and they come right back. Chance got the shot stopped there by Rollison, and Heino and Chance are involved, and punches are being thrown and gloves being dropped, and here we go. Messier involved as well.
Interesting to see what the call is going to be here, because Chance came in late and he looked like he might have thrown a right. After Heino was battling in front on the good rebound attempt, Rollison made the save. I didn't see the referee point to any one of the players. Looks like they're going to just let them battle it out right there.
Officials done a great job tonight so far.
Yep.
Outstanding job officiating.
There's a shot from the side. Rollison rebound. Keep your eye on the Messier's battling in front of the net. Heino gives, I can't see who that player is, on the right, Messier. Chance comes in late. That's what I thought Chance was going to get the call on the roughing. So he might have got away with one.
Crowd is back, buzzing. Another capacity crowd at the Pepsi Center. Tanguay was taken down, but he tripped Mitchell. And Forsberg went out of his way to run Walls. And we'll see who's going to get called. It's a penalty coming up. Forsberg took a real run at Walls, but I think Walls got his stick up on Forsberg, and that'll be the call.
Yeah, but this is interesting because Walls was releasing the puck, and then he was getting out of the way. And I didn't think that the stick got in it. I didn't think that the stick had gotten up, but the referee is obviously explaining that the elbow, the hands had gotten up, and I was worried about Forsberg losing his chiclets right into the glass. That's what I thought at first. Peter goes in for the hit. Oh, boy. You can see the helmet go back, and the shaft of the stick must have got him right in the face. Whoa, man, did he go in hard.
Now, is that the follow-through motion by Walls? I don't even think Walls was putting his stick up to protect himself there.
Listen, I think the head of Peter Forsberg caught the bottom, the hands of Walls, and the momentum of his head hitting his hands caused his right hand to go over, flip over, and get him in the face. Completely unintentional and a close call to make.
And I can appreciate Mick Magoo, the referee, giving a full explanation. He doesn't have to do that, but gave Walls the explanation anyway and showed right or wrong what he saw. So it's Walls, the high stick at 13:53. Colorado's second power play of the game and a chance to cut it to a one-goal deficit now. Back to the point, and the shot from Morris was blocked. Rather, Hiduk, I beg your pardon. Here's Sakic now. Sakic for Blake, are cutting off the point play. So here's Sakic. He goes all the way across. Whoa. Hendrickson out to greet him, and a good play as it's tipped out to center ice.
Yeah, that's a low percentage play by Morris. All he had to do is hang on to it, buy a little bit of time, and he would have had a better avenue.
Hawk got a piece to tip it out. Here's Philippe Kubler, who started all the scoring for Minnesota. Schultz over there, off the glass, kept in by Blake, but just barely. School off his skate. And here's Dupuis trying to break. Dupuis, backhander, saved by Patrick Roy.
Wow.
Turned over. And nearly right to Dupuis for another chance. During the regular season, Minnesota scored 9 shorthanded goals, but 8 of them came at home, just 1 on the road. At center now. Here's Tanguay in. Tanguay shot. Stopped by Rollison. Non-stop action here in Denver tonight. Tanguay will throw it down. Tanguay. Forsberg shot. Off Rollison at the post. And then Hajduk shot it wide. Gavrik on the blind backhand clearance. Kept in. He turned it over. Shot blocked as Walls is out of the penalty box. Race for the puck. Foot will get their foot. Their first icing is called. The Minnesota Wild, 3 goals in 4 minutes and 20 seconds span against Patrick Roy. on the board for Colorado.
Hey, Smith, you get a raise?
No, I got an Optima.
Introducing the Kia Optima midsize sedan.
Smith got a raise and options.
With available V6.
VP?
10-year, 100,000-mile warranty.
Smith's taking over.
Smith. And a starting price around $16,000.
Watch your back, Smith.
Smith Worldwide.
It'll just look like you got a raise. The Kia Optima. Right now, get 0% financing or up to $3,000.
Attention. By proclamation, I hereby declare that Car Dudes is moving.
But your judgeship, I love Car Dudes. Where will I go? What will I do?
Take it easy, son. Car Dudes is moving just south of the mall on 52 to a bigger and better location.
But...
where bad credit, slow credit, and no credit are still no problem. And right now, you can save big with Car Dudes' gigantic tax sale and let Uncle Sam take care of your down payment.
Get to Car Dudes today, now just south of the mall on US 52.
I'm Annette Medrano. My son Andrew was born 3 months early and spent almost 6 weeks in the hospital fighting for his life. His twin brother Rudy was born even earlier. He did not survive. Today, Andrew is a happy, healthy 14-year-old. However, many families continue to struggle with the often severe, long-term effects of premature birth. Help fight prematurity. Sign up for Walk America today. Register online at walkamerica.org.
Joe Sakic scored his 66th career playoff goal to get the Avs on the board. Battaglia and Reinbrecht get the helpers. Thought I heard a whistle, and I did. Tough to hear with the crowd. 13:22 is the time of the Sakic goal. Joe Sakic, 66 playoff goals, 26 more than the entire Minnesota team. Coming up on the Dodge Intermission Report, the Red Wings are in overtime. They get double overtime. There's an Islanders suspension and the rough stuff with their series with Ottawa. And a recap of the Frozen Four that is down to the Frozen Two. Thrilling overtime game seen earlier here tonight on ESPN2. Minnesota winning that game.
Oh,
all the way across. We have tried to make the play. New Hampshire won their game 3-2 over Cornell. And they will meet Minnesota in the final. Our AT&T storyline. And what else can it be? The Minnesota Wild. 3 goals and 420 to take a 3-0 lead that is now 3-1.
Our AT&T storyline replays. It's all about the Wild. Kuba power play goal. Perfect feed there. Running shot, rebound. Gabbert's first playoff goal. Wes Walsh. He has been a defensive specialist all season long. He makes it a 3-0 game. And as you mentioned, Joe Sakic has rebounded from Ryan Brecht and Battaglia to make this 3-1.
Off the draw. Wah had to be ready. And Foot will play it. Minnesota's done a pretty good job after giving up the goal of remaining cool and calm as they pick off the pass at center. Here's Dowd. He's got the shooting lane at the mark. Makes the pass instead for Gabbert, and it was deflected. Far side, here's Schantz. Schantz has had a very active game. Hasn't seen a whole lot of ice, but when he's been called upon, he's played very well. Here's Foot on it, far side. High note, bit of a pick. Here's Hendrickson. 2-on-1 down low. And Hendrickson was checked as it developed into a 2-on-2. Wah his belly makes the save and couldn't corral the rebound. Morris was there. We get a whistle as some players come together. A new feature throughout the Stanley Cup playoffs for our crew. It's dangerous, folks. It's Darren Pang with a camera at the morning skate. Pangervision.
Here it is, and here we're going to show the Minnesota Wild and what they do very well. Transition game. Every one of their forwards are interchangeable parts. They work at this relentlessly. Moving the puck, D to D, staggering the D, tape to tape, moving it with confidence. We haven't seen a lot of that in this hockey game. The confident puck movement going in as a five-man group. We'll keep our eye on that. When they're comfortable, they do that as well as any team in the National Hockey League. That one's going to go out of play, and that faceoff will be in the neutral zone by Willie Mitchell.
But that provides us a great excuse if the video's not that good, it's out of focus, or missing a shot. It's because Panger is shooting the video himself, not a professional cameraman.
Well, Mr. Orloff helps me out a little bit right there.
But it is Panger vision.
I am trying. And anytime you can watch Jacques Lemaire's great practices, you learn a great deal as a fan. You learn a great deal as a peewee hockey coach or us broadcasting. And clearly, they're a team that they go tic-tac-toe and they continue to move the puck.
Jacques Lemaire already in the Hall of Fame. Ducked it back in 1984. He's been there for some time. Now trying to do something special in Minnesota with a Wild team. He really, Ayo told us honestly, did not believe they would make the playoffs during training camp. Did not even think about it. Didn't mention it to the team until February. Not even making the playoffs. And here they are in a 3-6 matchup of the Western Conference and with a 3-1 lead late in the second. Trying to scream in from the wing. He was hooked off the play. And it's back out to center ice. Sackett just onside as he twirled at the blue line. Sekerash on it.
Credit Park, Richard Park, for driving hard to the net. Once he was hooked up, he didn't go down. Stayed on his feet to try to make a play.
Turned over to Hajduk. He finds Tenge now. Nice patient move. Skoula's got a lane. The Lister is stopped by Rollison. Rollison's lost his helmet. That might have been the second save he's made tonight, thanks to his mask.
You're right about that. Remember, he had that one in the opening period as well, right straight, right on the face. And he's okay. His defenseman, Sekeras, goes right over to him. Say, you okay? Keep your eye on the mask of Rollison. Nice play by Tange, right to the point, right off the lid, and it clips part of his mask, part of the tab that keeps the back skull piece, back of the head piece onto the front, there's a little plastic button there. And once that gets snapped off, he just released it and pushed it off, and that's a good play, because otherwise it's going to be moving in his head, and if he continues to play that way, he's going to have bad vision. So he knocked it off, and the referee automatically blows it down.
Right, that's the other advantage, right? If you try to play with it on, you can't see, and the referee's forced to allow play to keep going.
Absolutely. It's going to turn, and your peripheral vision is going to be eliminated. So good play by Rollison.
He's made a lot of good plays tonight. Final minute 8. Oh. Wild look to break. It's Gavrik in shot, saved by Wall. That might have caught him in the mask. Up high.
Nice pass by Walsh. If he passed it before, it's going to be a two-line offside pass. It was perfect.
Final minute. One touch going to cross the line. Hajduk spilled by Zuzan. Loose puck. Dupuis tied up his man. Wild unable to clear. Here's Foot able to hold in. And Dupuis able to backhand out the center. Final 40 seconds here. Big hit by Rob Blake on Jason Marshall. And Blake will calm things down in his own end.
In the last 5 minutes, the Wild have had 3 odd man breaks.
Wilsey shot, deflected wide. Good forechecking here by Colorado. Back to the point, here's Blake. Tricky pass for Sackett now. Straddling the blue line. Blake shot blocked by Ronning, and he'll get up slowly. We saw in the pregame warm-up clip, Ronning took a shot off his foot. He's got to skate to the bench, and the Wild really fortunate there. That the horn sounded, signaling the end of the second period.
Good shot block, though, by Ronnie. And those are the little things you have to do to win hockey games.
What is going on in Denver? 2 periods complete. First ever Stanley Cup playoff game for the Wild. They lead 3-1 after 2. John and Ray are coming up on the other side.
Ooh, you're a naughty little boy, aren't you? Keep it up, and I'm going to give you a spanking. I'll teach you the meaning of respect. You're not getting any of my butt light. Do you hear me? No kisses for you. Not till you learn to obey me. Now, get down on all fours.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Here we go. Here we go, Bertie.
Come on, Kelly.
Okay, here we go. I'm spinning around. Two,
come on,
three,
Kelly.
Four.
Okay, go.
Let's go.
Oh, no.
Hey,
oh,
wait.
Stop. This is out of control. How am I supposed to manage all of this? No, that's not what I mean.
Look, I just want this to work with that. That's not a solution. What am I paying you for?
Hey, honey, I got on that earlier flight out of Boston. Can you still pick me up?
Sure, I'll be there.
Great, I'll see you in L.A.
Life's good when you're Kristen Davis. But life's better when you're Kristen Davis and you have the cell phone with a walkie-talkie.
Hello?
Coast-to-coast walkie-talkie service coming soon, only from Nextel.
I thought I'd never be able to stop smoking, but with the Commit lozenge, I've got hope.
I've tried quitting before, but this time, I feel stronger than my cravings.
For anyone who's tried to quit and failed, there's hope. Introducing the Commit lozenge, clinically proven to help you stop smoking. Even if you've tried before, Commit delivers strong, craving-fighting medicine, and it keeps working even after the lozenge is gone.
I can actually see myself without a cigarette.
The Commit lozenge. Real help. Real hope.
We're not sure yet.
Welcome to the Dodge Intermission Report.
With Ray Ferraro, I'm John Butchergoss. Welcome in. Night number two has turned to a very interesting one again as the lower seeds having a strong playoff season thus far. We start with the 2-7 matchup in the Western Conference. The Red Wings home to the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. And we pick it up with J.S. Jaguar and Curtis Joseph. And boys, both these guys with their A games in this one. We're going to right to overtime. Look at Jaguar stopping Chris Draper there. Later, Havlid the shot. This hits Woolley and somehow doesn't go in.
And it hits Woolley from the back here. Luke Robitaille later walks in, beats Jaguar clean over the glove. The Red Wings think it's in. Robitaille thinks it's in. You're going to see the replay here. Off the crossbar, off the post, no goal.
Second overtime as we speak. And looky here, the Mighty Ducks and the Red Wings. The Red Wings have really carried the play throughout. But boy, J.S. Jaguar has been the number one star thus far. But Cujo also has played very well for Detroit. So the Red Wings, Ray, begin their quest to repeat as Stanley Cup champions. Last year, lost the first two games to the Canucks. From what you see this year, and you played against them last year, any difference as they begin their run tonight?
Well, certainly the one difference would be in goal, naturally, with Curtis Joseph in instead of Dominic Hasek. And Joseph has had a very uneven year. He has been good at times, but really has not been anywhere near the dominating goalie that they thought they were getting when they signed him as a free agent. He's played better of late, struggled the last weekend of the season, but has played very well tonight. On defense, they're missing Yuri Fisher, who's a big part of their defense. They did add Matthew Schneider from the Los Angeles Kings at the deadline. That's a little bit of a difference up front. And Zetterberg, the young rookie, playing with Hull and Datsyuk. This is a very talented, skilled team. They've been all over Anaheim through most of the first overtime, and if it's not for J.S. Jaguar, three or four times this game's looked over.
Detroit has lost their last five home playoff games, which is a bit strange.
Unbelievable that could happen to them.
Ray finished up his career last year with St. Louis. Blues begin tonight in Vancouver, and boy, your ex-Blues are off to a very, very good start. You live in Vancouver, so you can't go crazy here. Yep. Corey Stillman redirects the Doug Waite power play slap shot, and then just moments ago, it's Tyson Nash making it 2-0, Ray.
Nasher needs a couple of chances from in front. He stays with it. The Canucks don't clear anybody out. Brian Allen playing instead of Matthias Olund, who is still injured for Vancouver, doesn't pick Nash up quickly in the first period. 2-0 St. Louis. And Vancouver is reeling a little bit. They stumbled into the playoffs. It's a good start for the Blues.
All right. Well, our game, another surprise. Avalanche and the Wild. After 40 minutes, it's all Wild.
This intermission report, presented by Dodge, the official road team of the NHL. Grab life by the horns. Dodge.
That thing got a Hemi?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Woo! The all-new Dodge Ram Heavy Duty.
Did you mean the Charger? Because, you know, that's got a Hemi, too.
Now with a 345-horsepower, 5.7-liter Hemi Magnum. Ram Heavy Duty. Enough muscle to grab Motor Trend's 2003 Truck of the Year Award.
Give me a backpack.
We got it!
Can I write a check?
Yo.
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 Can I write a check?
Yo.
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 Can I write a check?
Yo.
Next time you use the Visa check card instead of checks, it'll get you in, out, and on with life.
Yo.
Gee. Yo, gee.
Yo.
If trips to you mean suitcases on rollers, if your dining guide isn't a gas food lodging sign, if you don't get beyond two-day growth, or ever use a tanker truck as a vanity mirror, get out of the way. Traditional styling, modern engineering, the Suzuki Volusia. Get out of the way.
Papa John's. After 19 years, no question. It's an amazing pizza.
Celebrate Papa John's 19th anniversary. Get two large one-topping pizzas for just $11.99. Call us now. We'll be right there.
Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's.
The Transporter on DVD. Now with 15 minutes of unrated extended fight scenes. The Transporter. Buy it Tuesday. Welcome back to the Dodge Intermission Report.
With 32 seconds last night in the Islanders' Game 1 win over Ottawa, Eric Goddard, high stick on Chris Neal, got a double minor, while today he also got suspended for Game 2 by the NHL. Back to the playoff ice, and let's start with the Bolts and Capitals. First-year coach Bruce Cassidy and his Caps taking on the Tampa Bay Lightning. Mike Greer pass across. Right to Robert Lang, who knocks it right out of midair, Ray.
He knocks it out of midair, as you say. It goes off the Tampa defenseman, Lukowich, and Lang tucks it over the glove of Javi Bullen, gives Washington the 1-0 lead.
This was an amazing move by LeCavalier.
Great skill by LeCavalier. He goes to leave it behind on the backhand, but Kolzik stays with it, makes a great pad save.
Look at Sergei Gonchar. What a pass to Kip Miller, who finds Michael Nylander. The Washington Capitals win Game 1 in Tampa Bay. Final score of 3-0, 2 for Lang, 1 for Nylander. First career playoff goal for Michael Nylander in his 19th career playoff game. Only the goalie, 28 saves for the shutout. After 40 minutes, it's all Wild, but Joe Sakic, last 43 playoff games, 23 playoff goals. He comes through again.
Nervous about foot odor and wetness? Get Odor Eater's Foot Powder and kick the problem. Odor Eater's Powder gives protection on demand. Even kicks out heavy-duty odor and sweat.
Now put Odor Eater's in, kick foot odor and wetness out.
Hey, you're going to love this new Quick Rent at National Car Rental.
When you get to the airport, they let you choose your own car.
Whatever make and model you want.
Whatever color you want.
You can walk right past the counter.
And you don't stand in any lines.
All you need is a major credit card and access to the internet. You rent online at nationalcar.com.
They ought to call it quick and easy.
Bypass the counter.
You don't have to stand in line.
Choose your own car.
Click, click, click on the computer.
It's all about me. Rent, huh?
Choose the rental car company that lets you choose your own car. Quick Rent at nationalcar.com.
Michelin designed the cross-terrain SUV tires specifically for SUVs to help provide responsive handling and a smooth ride. You'd be surprised just how smooth. Michelin, because so much is riding on your
So close! Within a hair, but not quite there. The hair stays for April Savings Day. Right now, get savings up to 10 grand or financing as low as zero APR on Toyota, Honda, Jeep, Lincoln, Mercury, Subaru, Mitsubishi, Hyundai, and more. If you're in the market for a new car, the Bob Romanato Group is here for you.
There's only one Bob Roman.
The Bob Romanato Group, Sagamore Parkway, Teal Road, Creasy Lane, Lafayette.
Need cash? Head for Cash Loan and Security. They'll buy your stuff. Cash Loan and Security, US 52. Like to shop? Cash Loan and Security offers guitars, VCRs, duels, video games, big TVs, diamond rings. Save big! Cash Loan and Security, US 52. Get cash quick with Cash Loan and Security's payroll advance. Your personal check puts money in your pocket now. Cash Loan and Security, US 52. Need a loan? Cash Loan and Security loans money on items of value. Bring it in. Walk out with cash. Cash Loan and Security, one block south of Union.
Dodge Intermission Report continues. I'm John Butchergoss with Ray Ferraro. Minnesota defending national champions. Boy, what a good night in Minnesota for hockey.
Great night for Minnesota. They come back and win it kind of on a weak goal that went through Al Montoya's legs, and Michigan's fine freshman goaltender.
Gophers win, Wild winning. Meanwhile, it'll be Minnesota and New Hampshire for the national championship on ESPN Saturday, 7 o'clock Eastern Time. NHL playoff schedule. For Friday, Bruins, Devils. Devils up one game to love. Then your ESPN 2 game, Maple Leafs, Flyers. And Ray Ferraro makes his analyst debut. He'll be with Dave Strader for the Edmonton Star game right here on ESPN 2. Watch and root Ray on. Thanks, Sean.
This intermission report, presented by Dodge, the official road team of the NHL. Grab life by the horns. Dodge.
The Dodge SXTs. Four cool cars. And you won't have to work two jobs just to buy one.
Don, you made it!
I like your hat.
Hit it! Grab Dodge's 770 powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match it.
Well, it's really good.
You were so cute when you met my dad for the first time.
Oh, he's real big. He's like 6'6", and he's got a beard. He looks like Abe Lincoln.
Oh, dear.
I need to go to the men's room. You want to come with me?
Sure.
Your hair looks great tonight.
Thanks. Just got it done.
Did you bring a comb?
Oh, yeah, of course.
You're not a woman. Why use a woman's shampoo? Try new Suave for Men deep cleaning shampoo. Get your hair just as clean as her brand for half the price. New Suave for Men.
Aw, yeah, summertime. Flip-flop, small top, party bumping non-stop. So much ice in my cooler, you think I was a jeweler. Bling, catching rays, making plays. Summer got more zap than a microwave. Dink, blue eyes, green eyes, brown eyes too. All the honeys checking who? The king of Malibu.
The silver bezel. I had lotion on my hands. I burn easily.
Why do I go to Pep Boys for service? Because they want to be champs. Last season, we went through an alternator, a radiator, and 32 air fresheners.
I don't have a lot of money.
So dealers are not an option, and not driving to tournaments isn't an option either. With Pep Boys, I get exactly what dealers offer for less.
Import or domestic, we'll help you get the most out of your car.
Our ASE certified technicians use the best parts and equipment.
Dealer quality service at prices you can afford.
Pep Boys, we're car people.
I have to go back to my convention. I know, but I have a convention. Bueno? Come on. I have to go. My convention. I know. I wish I could stay. We got married. I have to go. I love you. I'll call you. But you know one more thing. Yeah. Oh, you smell so good, huh?
Finals tickets. Trip to the finals. Sweet.
Enter the AT&T Ultimate Fan Zone Sweepstakes for a chance to win a trip for two to an NBA Finals game. Watch the NBA on ESPN Friday nights to see if you've won.
My bags are packed.
Oh, yeah.
Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN2 brought to you by Dodge, the official road team of the NHL. Grab life by the horns, Dodge. Armorall Protectant Wipes. Armorall, shine and protection now in a wipe. And Best Buy, the latest technology and entertainment all in one place. set for third period action from the Pepsi Center in Denver, Colorado. Bit of a shocker brewing here. The Wild, their first ever playoff game, leading the Avalanche by a score of 3-1. Steve Levy alongside Darren Pang. I know it's a different season, but during the regular season, Minnesota didn't lose a single game when leading after two. Obviously, Colorado can come back. They've got the talent.
Great desperation from Colorado's point of view. And it's fair to say right now that the next goal wins the hockey game. Obviously, if it goes 3-2, momentum in the home building, everything turns around. All the things you did so well in the regular season, if you're the team leading like Minnesota in this situation, you tend to see things a little differently now. Obviously, they make it 4-1. It's lights out and head over to game number two.
We will have that game for you. Many of you will see it on ABC Saturday afternoon. 1 o'clock face-off time, mountain time. Icing is called some 9 seconds into the third period. Gonna find out something about the Wild in this period too.
We will. And let's go back to the goals that they scored. Steve, they're all on the same side of the ice. From Patrick Waugh's point of view, they all come to his left, to the glove side. And this play here by Wes Walls jamming to make it a 3-0 game. So good work by the Wild to get in tight. Patrick Waugh had no chance on any of the three goals.
Very astute point, though, that all coming from that same side. Well, I doubt that's a scouting report. It might just be coincidence.
It's their strength, I bet.
Right, their strength, not Patrick's weakness. And no, does he have a weakness? No,
don't see any.
Here's Gavrik. He'll hit the brakes. Marion Gavrik has got a goal on the game. Finds Loxonen towards the front of the net. Couldn't hit Wells, who also has a goal in the game. Mitchell's shot. Missed the mark. This is the kind of start Minnesota wanted to have. At least pin Colorado in their own end just a little bit. Right back of the half. What a move by Tanguay, but can't make a second move around Kuba. Mitchell for Walls. Out at center now. Here's Ronning, let it go. Blocker down by Waugh. And the rebound cleared out to center ice. Turned over at center to Battaglia. He'll let it go. Rollison the save. It'll hang on.
Well, good to see Cliff Ronning back on the ice. He's their most experienced postseason performer. And Cliff Ronning obviously isn't a big guy. 5'7", 175 pounds. This came at the very end of the second period. Ronning blocked that shot and could barely get off the ice as time trickled away and the period did end. But it's those little things that need to be done in the playoffs, and he knows that. He went to the finals in 94 with Vancouver.
Shot blocked. Rollison will take a look. Sekeraj had it. He was dumped and lost it. Back to the point. Shot. Stopped by Rollison. The rebound is shot wide. It was leg there in the crease momentarily.
You know, I bet the referee was telling him to play the puck, and his own instincts were saying, cover it up, take a whistle. It's not a bad thing to do when you're on the road. Quiet things down. But he shouldn't have played it because it kept play alive.
Minnesota was a pretty good road team during the regular season. They were a game over 500. They come right back. Here's Brunette. Drop for Dowd. Backhand. Tried to give it across. Back to Brunette. Brunette's behind the net now. Out there with Johnson and Dowd. And a heavy duty hit. Heinold put Matt Johnson down on the ice.
Good hit by
Heino. Tough a guy as Matt Johnson is. I think Johnson's been on more on the receiving end of big hits than any he's doled out so far tonight.
Well, when you're flat-footed, it's hard to get your balance, and Heino had some momentum. So Heino was able to move 13 in the white. Good hit right there on Johnson. Real good hit right there. I thought Heino's had a pretty decent game here. Here's the chance before. Oh, my. Jimmy Dowd's got a chance to shoot it. He went to the backhand, and Brick, all of Brick, New Jersey, is sitting there saying, Jimmy, you got to shoot that puck. And I bet if he had it over again, and once you go to the bench, the guys are saying, put it on net.
Shot whistled high over the net. His buddy's back at the bowling alley.
Absolutely.
Shoot the puck. Shot. Rossi shot the puck and missed it, and then he slaps his stick down in disgust. Heino was involved with Brunette, and Heino lost a helmet on it. Full change for Minnesota. Colorado able to come out easily with a bam. Mitchell will calm it down. Finds Kuba up the near side. Here's Gabbert trying to catch the abs in a change. Gabbert tried the sneaky shot. Waugh played it off the end. Here's Forsberg deep in his end. So while the Wild are a solid road team, the Avalanche are awesome at home. Colorado's last home loss, mid-January. Rollison will hang on to that off the rush by Tenge. Colorado's last regulation loss here, January 16th against Detroit. That's 18 games in the home whites without losing in regulation.
Well, it's been a good battle as Dwayne Rollison has seen Wes Walsh, his defensive centerman, and Peter Forsberg. Here's what happened in the second period. Wes Walsh got a minor for high sticking, and it was because of the action of Peter Forsberg, who could have got called for a charge on that same play, but definitely the momentum of Peter caused the stick to come up, and that's why Wes Walsh has got the puck again right now. He's had a good game.
Walsh comes out at center, in across the line, tried to beat Foote and Blake, and that's not going to happen too often. Maybe never. Here's Hayden. He's hit by Loxton. Forsberg was taken down in a big way. He's looking around. There's some yapping going on the ice.
Yeah, good line change there, though, by Jacques Lemaire. Once that play was on his side of the ice, full wholesale changes, all five guys on and off the ice.
Here's Ronning shooting it in. And at this point, anytime you get it deep into the Colorado end, that's a good play by Minnesota. Reinfrecht away from Hendrickson. And the Avs come out. They're onside with Sakic. Hits the brakes away from Sekerash. Sakic turned it over to Hendrickson. Here's Park at center now. He's caught from behind. Ronning trying to force the issue on Morris now. Loose puck in the corner. DeVries up the near side for Battaglia. He's pinned to the boards by Kuba. The defenseman's in deep. Play still allowed to continue on to the Colorado end. Good board work here by Minnesota. Here's Joltok on it now. Joltok behind the net. Couldn't connect down the pass. Brunette will cycle it down deeper. It's one of Minnesota's strengths, cycling the puck. Valuable seconds ticking away. Here's Brunette. Oh, put it on goal. Saved by Waugh. Johnson there from his knees. Just too hard away from Brunette. And Battaglia deep in his own end. With crisscrossing the signals. And the crowd cheering the Avs. They can't get out of their own end. And finally they do. Here's Battaglia skipping through. Zuzan tried to pump it out and couldn't. Wilson is checked by Kuba down to the ice. Here's Marshall. Just able to get it across the line. Hino trying to go back in. Good job to stay on his feet through the Zuzan hook. Here's Skula. Works it down deeper now. The Avs have to get something going. Heidel put it through traffic and through everybody all the way to the wall. Here's Messier. Good job by this energy type line for Colorado. Here's Wilsey.
Nice move.
Off the back of the net to himself. Back for Marchman. Hold, and it's blocked by Marshall, whose heart. Play allowed to continue on, and it's tipped off the glass. And out of play.
Nice shot blocked by Marshall. You can tell he's got an experience as a defenseman. And obviously Jacques Lemaire has thrown him into the forward ranks, but that was a classic two-pad slide shot block that I believe got him in the rib area or hip area, but it clearly wasn't in the knee. Marchman brings it back. The shot goes right around the numbers. Yeah, right in the back part of it. Now, the referee doesn't blow it down right away because the Minnesota Wild have to have control of the puck, and or the referee thinks that there is a really serious injury, and that wasn't the case right there. It wasn't in the facial area, so once the puck went over the net and around the boards, then they can blow it down, and it's a good call. The Wild, very disciplined, very structured. They've had 15 block shots tonight, and this has not been their best performance. And we've seen them play some games where they have completely shut down their opponents and have been in utter control throughout the game. They've been in desperate mode a lot of times in this hockey game, but they're doing the little things right and enough to have a 3-1 lead.
Face-off upcoming. To the right of Dwayne Rollison. He's faced 35 Colorado shots and stopped 34 of them. 36th shot on goal, and he's got that one, and there won't be 37 right now. Morris let it go off the clean faceoff win.
Hey, those faceoff wins late in hockey games, they're so pivotal. Joe Sakic taking the draw, Dwayne Rollison getting down low, Nice butterfly and no rebound.
Sakic, another great face-off win. Morris will let it go again. It's another shot block. Make it 16. If you're scoring at home, Gavrik. That was pretty close to closing his hand down on the puck, and I think the crowd thought the same thing, but he got away with it. Here's Sakic at center, off for Reinfrecht. Reinfrecht had a step, but Sakic put it off his skate. And the Avs will go back deep in their own end.
Keep your eye on Joe, because the Walsh line's doing a good job against Forsberg, and it opens up some room here.
Offside ahead of the play. 3-1 Minnesota, 13:31 to play in regulation.
See you next week.
See you, Bill.
Good job, man.
Rusty, what's hurt?
Hey, I'm just trying to get home.
Introducing the Dodge SRT Series. Race inspired, street legal.
Sweet. Hit
it! When your first name is Armor, you don't just clean and shine, you protect with just a wipe. Armor All Protectant Wipes.
Dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls. Just dial right down the center, 1-800-CALL-ATT.
It's free for you and cheap for them.
Don't touch that!
Save on every call. Dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
She's all you'd ever want. She's the kind I'd like to fault and take to dinner. But she always knows her place. She's got style, she's got pace. She's a winner.
About the Stanley Cup playoffs being back on ESPN and ESPN2. You get NHL tonight on ESPN2. Coming up after the game, John, Barry, and Ray. The Ducks and the Red Wings thinking about triple overtime. The Capitals and Lightning, at least if you look at the score, appear to be somewhat one-sided. And the latest on the Leaf injuries. I mean, Toronto, one game into the playoffs, and they're already banged up.
They play that style, boy. They play with reckless, emotional abandon. And you got to love them as a group. They play hard.
Kept it, blocks in it, gloved it down, but it was taken away. Here's Blake. He'll just flip it down the ice. No ice, and Rollison will play it, and it'll be whistled down. Can't get enough of Panger vision already, only in our first night. I need some more. Give me my fix.
Well, a lot of teams, they work on the faceoffs. The man in the middle of your screen is their head coach, Jacques Lemaire, one of the great faceoff guys of all time. He's going to now start monitoring the faceoffs. They're working on it. They knew going into this game that if they had the puck before Forsberg got the puck, then they would have a better chance with puck control, obviously. So far in this period, they've only won two and lost five. They got to get her going here in the third period.
Love Pangervision. I wonder if Pangervision.com has already been taken. You might want to think about that.
Uh-oh, don't get that.
Here's Sakic. Drop pass. Reinfrecht. Zoos in good play. The quick stick to break up the pass. Here's Sakic on it now. Sakic at the blue line for Battaglia. Nice feed for DeVries. Gives it back to Battaglia. They cycle it again. Sakic went across the ice. Foot had left his position, and Gavrik finds himself with time and space, but didn't move it quick enough. Backhander by Sakic is stopped by Rollison, and Gavrik's got to be quicker with his decision in his own end. Brunette on the forecheck. Marchman went for the body. Let somebody else on his team play the ball.
Oh, too many men on the ice. Holy jumping. There had to have been 8 or 9 guys on the ice for the Wild.
Puck into the netting, and that's the reason for the whistle. Not too many men on the ice. 8 minutes into the third.
Well, Joe Sakic had a glorious scoring chance. Not only does he possess a wicked wrister, but he's got a wonderful backhander as well. Good. There you're talking about Gabbert. He's got to make up his mind earlier. You're right, Steve. The puck goes right on the tape. Joe Sakic's going to grab it right here. Puck's rolling. Good decision by Sakic, trying to get Rolison committing to his left. And he put it back to the right. Great save with the toe.
Rolison's already established himself as having a great game tonight. But you get the sense he's going to have to be even better here in the latter stages of the third. Shot never made an odd goal. Blake pushed it ahead, back to Mars' shot. That was blocked. Blocked by Hadou towards the front of the net. Tanguay on it. Quick shot by Blake. I'm not sure that made it all the way through. And off of Marshall and out the center. Good to see Marshall back on the ice. Some confusion at the blue line there. As Joltach was dumped, penalty coming up. And Tanguay goes straight to the penalty box. He does not pass go, does not collect $200. And Tanguay with his second minor of the game. First one was really costly.
And keep in mind, the Wild have scored two power play goals. One with Tanguay in the box. Turnover at the blue line. He gets the blade of his stick right on the thigh, right between the leg, the pant leg, and the top of the shin pad, and drags him down.
Football swinging around and clear. Tanguay for hooking at 8:42. Third power play of the game for Minnesota. As you mentioned, they are 2 for 2. They got the 2 goals on just 3 power play shots. Rattles around on the glass. Chance in deep on this penalty kill. Here's Joltach. He'll go back to the point. Ronning's got a lane. Messier went down for the block. Shot. Joltach, a second chance. He fired it wide. Gavrik on it now. Zuzan in a battle in front. He lost his stick. And wow, it just rolled off Brunette's stick. Fanning on the shot. Wide, but to gobble it up.
Wonderful play by Cliff Ronning at the point. This morning, Cliff said, I don't even know if I'm playing the point right now. But the side of the ice to focus on here. Good play by Cliff there. Stop it here again, guys, because this is the side of the ice that everything's going towards, and it's causing Patrick to go to the left. This one here, Joltach shot again right from the slot. A close attempt and a quality scoring chance. Minnesota's generating very, very good scoring chances, but with the power play, not necessarily at even strength.
Here's Heino with a step. He's got great speed, looking to break on Kuba, and it's swung around. A minute 10 left on the penalty. Heino swings Ronning around. Here's Sakic now. Sakic will slow down Joltach. And now Minnesota will wind it up. Here's Joltach at center, across the red line, fires in. Park on the forecheck. Blake took a pretty good piece of him. And it's cleared out to center ice.
Whoop. Joltach needs a line change, so calmly he puts it back to his goalie, Rolison.
Had that work out?
Oh, not very well.
Chance nearly stole it away. I'm not sure they're going to do that again. Wow. Chance has had a couple of scoring opportunities to there. Tonight he also had to be out of gas. I would say Rolison wouldn't want that pass again.
I thought I saw Jacques Lemaire go right over to Joltach. I might be wrong, but that would be an exchange in which it would say, not again. Not again to Rolison. It's not Marty Brodeur back there handling the puck.
Wallow swinging around. Penalty coming up. Penalty coming up. 9 seconds left on the Tanguay penalty. So we'll be even for 9 seconds. And then the Avs will go to the power play.
15 green. I got a minor penalty. Hooking.
Second hooking call of the game on Andrew Brunette. And Jacques Lemaire, as I mentioned before, there's the call right here. His stick is wedged between the legs originally on DeVries, and then it slid out, and then it went beside the body. Here's the play by Joltach. He's going to get a line change. He's out of gas. He's been on the power play the whole time. Rolison tries to make one little fake maneuver on Chance. That would have really turned the tide of this game around. Chance was unable to convert. The Wild got away with one.
Nick Magoo got the right call, not the right player. Dupuis for hooking at 10:33. So it'll be the third power play for Colorado, and it's underway right now. The sense is going to be some avalanche pressure over the next minute 35, but not right here. Here's Wall, short-handed. He'll rag the puck and kill some clock. Wes Wall now dangerously loses it in center. And it's shot around the boards. Kept in. Morris, Hayden. Schultz on, can't take it away. Now Forsberg.
creates some time and space. Here's Hayduk for Forsberg. Blake in front of the net. Back to the point. Here's Morris. Blake in the battle with Schultz locked up. Hayduk, one-time shot off the feed from Forsberg, and he missed the mark. Here's Hayduk again. Spins away, finds Blake. Off from Milan Hayduk, the 50-goal scorer. Finds Forsberg, the top scorer in the NHL this league season.
Oh, good play.
And gloved by Rolison.
That is a great read by Rolison. Backdoor play, gloved it on Peter Forsberg. Forsberg looking for that similar play that Andrew Burnett made to Kuba with their first power play goal. Oh, here's Peter looking for Hayduk originally. The pass was not in the wheelhouse. It was a little bit to the heel, and that's why Milan Hayduk pulled it. Hayduk has not had very many, if any, glorious scoring chances in this game. That has been taken away from this line.
Here's Foot lining up. 25 seconds left. Now the penalty to Dupuy. Zuzin, good body check there, and the crowd didn't like it. Here's Sackett now. Zuzin hit Reinprecht. Back to the point. Dowd was unable to clear the zone. Zuzin on Sackett now. Here's Battaglia. Reinprecht dives. Dupuy is out. Not a single shot on goal for the Avs during that power play, and that is surprising. Back to the point. Here's a shot. Knocked to the corner. You can hear the Wild from that great ESPN2 audio. The Wild teammates saying, ice it, ice it. They need a change. And they cooperate. 7:09 left. The Avs trailing by a pair.
Oh yeah, summertime. Flip-flop, small top, party bumping nonstop. So much ice in my cooler. You think I was a jeweler. Bling, catching rays, making plays. Summer got more zap than a microwave. Dink, blue eyes, green eyes, brown eyes too. All the honeys checking who? The king of Malibu.
The silver bezel. I had lotion on my hands. I burn easily.
Here's what's playing this month on Insights On Demand TV.
Go time.
You can start any movie anytime you want.
What else can you do?
Even pause, rewind, and fast forward, all with your Insight digital remote.
Oh!
No VCR or DVD player required.
No one in my family has ever gone out with a non-Greek before.
Oh! On Demand TV, only on Insight Digital Cable. What's your insight? Here's what's playing this month on Insights On Demand TV.
Go time.
You can start any movie anytime you want.
What else can you do?
Even pause, rewind, and fast forward. All with your Insight digital remote.
Oh!
No VCR or DVD player required.
No one in my family has ever gone out with a non-Greek before.
Oh! On Demand TV, only on Insight Digital Cable. What's your insight?
Levy, Dallin Pang, and our outstanding ESPN2 Stanley Cup playoff crew from a sold-out Rocket Pepsi Center in Denver. There's an upset brewing here. The Minnesota Wild, in their first ever Stanley Cup playoff game, lead the mighty Avs 3-1 with 7 minutes to play in regulation time. Blake on it. It'll be pushed back into the Colorado end softly, and Sakic will look to wind up away from Jason Marshall.
I like the way Sakic's playing. And now look who's, he's got Forsberg, Sakic, and Hayduk on the ice with 6.5 minutes to go. Tony Granato sensing the desperation right now.
Locks it and ties up with Mars. And that's been a big question here in the last few weeks in Denver. Who's going to score besides the Forsberg line? Shot is deflected off Wah and into the netting. And so far, that player has been Sakic. He's got the only goal for the Avs. Saturday, the Stanley Cup playoffs return to ABC at 3 Eastern, noon Pacific. Some of you will see the defending champion Red Wings host the Mighty Ducks. Others will see game 2 of our series, the Wild and the Avs, or the Capitals and the Lightning. Check your local listings for the Stanley Cup playoff game in your area. Wild have it back behind the Colorado cage. Heinonen on the back check finds Park. Away from Dupreeze.
Dowd got the shot away. Watt didn't know where it was momentarily. The Avs are able to get it out. Trying to spring Tanguay in their offside at the Minnesota blue line. Good hit at the Minnesota blue line. Forced the offside.
Well, Tony Granato showed some savvy there. Obviously going to the strengths with Forsberg and Sakic on the same line. But keep in mind that the defensemen for Tony Granato's hockey club are a big part of it. And the defensemen scoring goals in the last 20 games of the regular season has been a big, big part of it.
Hey, we talked to both coaches today. And both coaches said it helped their respective teams by watching last night's action. That, hey, Colorado wasn't going to get caught flat-footed watching Edmonton go into Dallas, watching the Islanders go into Ottawa. And Minnesota also said, hey, it's an advantage for us to see those teams on the road score upset victories. And they're working on one right now.
ESPN the magazine on newsstands now.
Hey, that thing got a Hemi, right?
Yeah.
Well, now I got a Hemi too, but I got something you don't got. Check this out.
Dodge Ram 1500. The Hemi legend continues. Grab Dodge's 770 powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match it. You like it cause you choose it. Most DJs won't refuse it. It ain't nothing like hip-hop music.
Hey, you're gonna love this new quick rent at National Car Rental.
When you get to the airport, they let you choose your own car.
Whatever make and model you want.
Whatever color you want.
You can walk right past the counter.
And you don't stand in any lines.
All you need is a major credit card and access to the internet. You rent online at nationalcar.com.
They ought to call it quick and easy.
Bypass the counter.
You don't have to stand in line.
Choose your own car.
Click, click, click on the computer.
It's all about me. Rent, huh?
Choose the rental car company that lets you choose your own car. Quick rent at nationalcar.com.
I like to skate. I don't like to sweat. I use Red Zone because it's the strongest stuff you can get, made just for guys. It absorbs in and helps stop sweat, period. Red Zone from Old Spice.
Talked about it earlier. Where's the offense going to come from if it's not the Forsberg line? Well, Sakic does have the goal, but the defense is more than chipped in for Colorado offensively over the final 20 games.
And that's something we have to look at here. Again, Tony Granato's got Sakic and Forsberg with Hejduk on the ice. Hejduk has not been sprung free for any quality chances. Look for the D to be extremely aggressive like they always are. They could be the difference.
And Tanguay is not on the Colorado bench. He went to the dressing room. Can't be sure if it's an equipment issue or an injury issue, but we'll let you know when we know for sure. Here's Forsberg now, and across the line. All five green sweaters back in position. Back to the point. Blake lets it go through a screen. Missed it. Marshall get to it and clear. You mentioned Marshall before the former defense. Really like having three defensemen on the ice when he's out there. And in this kind of situation, protecting a two-goal lead with 5 minutes left in the third makes a lot of sense.
Tanguay's back on the bench, so it's an equipment repair problem.
Here's Gavrik coming late, quick shot, glove save, rebound, Walls couldn't bury it. And it's in the crook of the arm of Patrick Waugh.
What a save that was. Tough play, perfect pass. And Minnesota starting to gain a little confidence with the puck. Right over to the far side, right-hand shot, wicked blast. And Richard Park just lets it rip from our Southwest Airlines goal cam. Patrick fights it off with the left side of his body, goes back to his left, and is able to corral the rebound as well.
Is that the crook of your arm?
Right in that, yeah, right in that. No, right between the elbow and that.
Here's a chance now. Chip that in front, loose puck, Minnesota will get to it. But it's kept in by Colorado. Back behind the net. Reinprecht on it. But the Wild are going to get there. Here's Park at center. Marchman will get to it. 4.5 to go in the third regulation time. Here's Marchman leading the rush. He's 1-on-4. Now has Sakic trailing him. Sakic takes it away from Schultz. Here's Sakic circling out of the circle. Wild able to get to it. Brunette one touch it there for Dowd. Brunette will force it in deeper. Wow. Mishandle it. Turn on the front and it's in. Andrew Brunette, I think, on Patrick Waugh. And with 4 minutes left in the third, it's 4-1 Minnesota.
Unbelievable here for the Wild. 4-1 lead. And with the puck down low, it took a bad bounce off the boards. Patrick Waugh nonchalantly played it with his skate. The puck was carrying back in front of the net. It went off the skate of Greg DeVries. And before Patrick could get back in the net, it goes into the far side. Dupuis was right there on the doorstep to tap it by.
And the fans start to head for the exits here in Denver. Many of them will do so flat out shaking their heads. Hand pass is the reason for the whistle with 3:48 left. And it's all over but the crying here in Colorado for game one.
Yeah, it sure is. Andrew Brunette's had a pretty good game here down low. One hand on his stick. He goes in, gets the puck right here, plays it off the skate of DeVries, and it's his goal. Dupuis was right there on the doorstep, and I didn't think he tapped it in before it went across the line, and he did. Brunette's going to get credit for that goal.
Unassisted, 16 minutes even. Second career playoff goal for Andrew Brunette.
Play down low now. And there's a lot of the magnifying glass will go on Patrick for giving that one up. But let's face it, a 3-1 hockey game, it was all about Dwayne Roloson in this game. Roloson's first period, the exhibition that he put on there, that's the determining outcome in this hockey game. He gave the Wild a chance while the Storm was at its highest in the first period on him.
Simply amazing that was a scoreless first period.
It was. He was in. Colorado played a great first period.
Sekeresh back for it up and will rub him out. Here's Hajduk coming out of the corner. Shot, score! Milan Hajduk through Roloson. Only now gets up off the ice. Making a 4-2 hockey game with 2:59 left.
Great work down low. And for the first time in this game, Hajduk was sprung loose here. A good pick by Greg DeVries. DeVries does that all the time. And this one gets through the arm, between the arm and the body of Roloson. Oh boy, what a play on Gaberick as well. That's why he's the Rocket Richard Trophy winner. 50 goals this year in the regular season, and that was his first good scoring chance in this game. I'd like to go back, though, on that pick by Greg DeVries again. He does that exceptionally well.
Shot to the corner. Kuba trying to put it off the glass and out of the zone. Delayed offside, no reason to whistle it down. Here's Gaberick now. All sorts of problems handling the puck. Here's Walls. Slap shot right on. And a save by Wild. Forsberg will get to it. 2:35 to play. Regulation time. It's a 4-2 Minnesota lead in the Wild's first ever Stanley Cup playoff game. The last goal, Hajduk. His first 22nd career playoff goal at 17:01. So each of the last two goals have been unassisted in this game. Here's Reinprecht on it. Couldn't hit Sakic. And the Wild will just take the clear from Pascal Dupuis. Although this will go for icing. 2:05 left.
Let's go back on this offensive pick by DeVries. He's very good at it. Stop it here, guys. Right here. Good pick. This allows Hajduk to come out. And the green jersey right there is Marian Gaberick. He's not strong on the stick as far as the deke by Hajduk is concerned. But I love the way DeVries jumps in like that. He did it in the first period. I made notice of that. He jumps in on that weak side or the strong side, causes a little bit of pick, a little bit of commotion. And if not, then Greg DeVries ends up getting the puck in an offensive situation. We have a timeout right here with 2:05 left to go.
Colorado will spend their timeout.
Now we go back to the goal that they just gave up. You know, by Patrick, and the way that they played that defensively. It was a sloppy decision, and it ended up being a funny carom off the boards, granted, But these ones end up at the time, it's 3-1, it goes to 4-1, right. You say, what the heck? And here's the goal. Here's the bounce. I'll take it off my foot. Okay, now Brunette's right there. Patrick comes in front. DeVries knocks it off his skate. Now it makes it 4-1, and you think, what's the big deal? But they turn around and score to make it 4-2.
And it's a bigger deal.
And it's a bigger deal, because it could be a 3-2 hockey game. His openers, 2.43 goals against average, 91%. He's 25-18. He's done everything you can ask for any goaltender to do, and I know that he doesn't like what happened in that goal.
Y is out. Extra attacker on. 2:04 to play, but they trail by two. Mitchell trying to slap it away. Backhands it to the point. Marr's able to keep in now. Here's Forsberg, checked by Schultz. Forsberg for Hayton. And the shot from the angle deflected high off the glass. Forsberg to Blake at the point. Kept in there. Net is empty. Blake will block that shot at the empty net. Ronning on it. Away from Sack, trying to keep it in deeper. Ronning, second chance. And Blake able to make the save before they hit the empty net. 85 seconds left in regulation time. And that'll be whistled out for a two-line pass with a minute 22 left here in the third. And Waugh still on the bench.
Yeah, he'll probably go back, I would imagine. As we take a look at the amp line here for the Colorado Avalanche, Tanguay, no points. Obviously, across the board, Hajduk has just scored. Six shots for Milan, two for Forsberg, two for Tanguay. And I get a lot of credit for the Minnesota Wild and the Wallace and the Gabrick and the Lauksonen line, on them at even strength.
I think there were many people who didn't feel Minnesota could score four goals in a playoff game, let alone against Patrick Waugh and the Avs. And he's got a 4-2 lead. Good bumping back behind the net. DeVries trying to force the issue now. Zsolta cleared it, but all the way down. So Foote will try to save every second. Icing called. 57 ticks remaining. They'll bring the faceoff back down deep into the Minnesota end.
Another critical faceoff here. Sakic will stay on the ice. Rolison knows that he's got to get outside, get on top of the crease, that all indications are he's going to get a shot on goal. And you got to make sure that you clear the puck, leave nothing around. 57 seconds left, and he's got a chance to win his first playoff game. And there's Wes Walsh on the ice for 27 to 4, 29. Even strength shifts. It's been a while since Rolison's won that playoff game, since subbing for Dominic Hasek and the Buffalo Sabres.
Walsh beats Sakic on the draw, Tanguay on the forecheck. Here's Tanguay for Sakic again. Forsberg behind the net. And there is no rebound with 40 seconds left. And Blake wants him to be careful to stay out. He's signaling his teammates to stay out, so the faceoff stays in.
Well, it's only his defensive partner, but it was Morris that jumped into the play. Morris is already involved in the play. He's coming in. But good play by Forsberg to get it back to Hajduk. It's a set play. Rolison has very good awareness. He has not left the post on those types of plays.
39 saves and counting.
Here's the key right here. You're obviously going to get points and traffic there if they can win the faceoff.
Sakic is a pile up on the faceoff as he was battling with Hendrickson. Hayden tried to tee up the one-timer, was checked. Net is empty. Floated towards the empty net and just wide. Blake back for the touch. And they're going to call the icing with 25.5 seconds left.
These are the details that I'm sure are driving Jacques Lemaire a little bit goofy. I mean, you've got to get the line. You can't be thinking empty net, or get the line, bury the game, get it over with. On that last sequence, we saw that this player here, Milan Hajduk, was the player that ended up right in this area here, and they were looking for him, but they're running out of time.
Here's Sakic on the faceoff. Joe lost that one. Back to the point, though. The Avs able to keep in. Hendrickson trying to get to it. Lost his edge and went down. Lauksonen over there turned it over. Here's Hajduk now. And it's taken away by Minnesota. Lauksonen slowly towards the net. Won't be icing, but it won't be a goal either. Here's Park trying to back in it. 3 seconds left. 2-1. And it is all over. The Minnesota Wild, behind the goaltending of Dwayne Rolison,
win their first ever Stanley Cup playoff game. They do it 4-2 in Colorado against the mighty Avalanche.
Good effort here by Dwayne Rolison. First playoff win since 99 when he won game one 5-4 in Toronto. He got some help. They weren't their best, though. I expect the Wild to be better, and I expect the Avalanche to be a more desperate team in game number two.
And the shocking results continue for the first two nights of the National Hockey League Stanley Cup playoffs. Tune in to ESPN2 tomorrow for a Stanley Cup playoff doubleheader, beginning at 7 Eastern when the Maple Leafs battle the Flyers. That'll be followed by the Stars hosting the Oilers. Coming up next, it's NHL Tonight. Tonight's game has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. For Darren Pang and our crew, this is Steve Levy. So long from Denver. John, back to you.
NHL Tonight is next. Defending champs begin their run, and you will not believe how that game ended. Vinny plays his first playoff game against the Capitals. As you just saw, a great night for the state of Minnesota, college and pro, and Blues and the Canucks. Game one in Vancouver. It's all coming up next.
Hello?
Hey, how you doing? You want to grab some dinner?
Oh, it's you. You don't call for ages, and I'm just supposed to say, hi, great, dinner, fine.
No, yeah, but
nothing. Did you hibernate or something?
Whoa.
Hey, screw around.
Shh. Yeah.
Look up, see blue, flip back blue.
You must be so hungry.
Oh, yeah.
You're gonna love this new quick rent at National Car Rental.
When you get to the airport, they let you choose your own car.
Whatever make and model you want.
Whatever color you want.
You can walk right past the counter.
And you don't stand in any lines.
All you need is a major credit card and access to the internet. You rent online at nationalcar.com.
They ought to call it quick and easy.
Bypass the counter.
You don't have to stand in line.
Choose your own car.
Click, click, click on the computer.
It's all about me. Rent, huh?
Choose the rental car company that lets you choose your own car.